Welcome to Admissions and 15 Adventures.
Throws have the three networks tied at 2 points apiece, CBS, NBC, and ABC. If you hit the target, you get 1 point. If you hit it hard enough, you get 3 points. Hard enough to dislodge, for instance, Bobby Conrad sitting right there. If you hit it hard enough, that bench opens up, the star goes into a water tank. Conrad pretends indifference, but only because Savalas can't throw very hard. And working with me, that man. Remember the 1973 Oakland Mets World Series? Reggie Jackson, the hero? He could run then. He could catch then. He could hit then. He could do everything then. He's still a superstar, of course. But right now, future team undetermined based upon the re-entry draft. Mackenzie Phillips, star of One Day at a Time, coming up. She missed her first two throws. Now she gets a final throw. Reggie Jackson, take over.
There's that control. She picks up a point there for her team. She showed good control in practice, and finally she hit it on her third attempt.
So CBS on this event assumes a one-point lead, and Conrad voices his own truculence. Jimmy Walker coming up now, the angular one. Throwing with an almost liquid grace, as you will see. Taking over. Reg?
I like your show, Jimmy. You're the best actor in it, Jimmy.
I saw Jimmy in practice. Not great form, but pretty good control. He knew he couldn't throw real hard, but he just tried to make contact.
How about that?
I don't like your show at all, Jimmy.
There it is. He picks up 2 points. In the clutch, he moves CBS's point total in this event up to five. So it's 5 points CBS, two for NBC and ABC. He knows what he's doing here, Bob Conrad, because coming up, Kevin Dobson of CBS's Kojak.
Man, he's got a great arm. No one could ever convince me that he hadn't been playing baseball all his life.
I don't understand why Conrad wasn't knocked into the tank on that. I've got to talk to Bobby about that.
Man, he went for broke right there. That guy's got a pretty good arm.
Well, they did very well in the baseball throw with a total of 6 points. So CBS has a substantial lead there. Oh, the robot, Mr. Holmes and Yo-Yo, ABC, John Shuck, the music, the stripper. Remember David Rose's interpretation? Let's quickly reset. We're in the battle of the network stars. The winning network out of 9 athletic events. The winning network, $20,000 per person. And while Shuck is apparently titillating the crowd with this act, Reggie, I wonder if you're being equally excited.
No, I don't even think the people, their faces aren't excited or anticipation. I don't see either.
Reggie, let me ask Bobby Conrad right here and now, how come he didn't go into the tank when Dobson hit the target?
Never thought you'd escape unscathed.
I don't understand it. Well, Kevin almost knocked the whole wall down.
Must have been the way you were sitting, because during the practice shots, people were going down like flies.
I think I just got lucky.
I think maybe they decided they like your show,
well,
after all.
I hate CBS anyway. I'm glad they didn't put me in the drink.
Here's a big man getting in here right now, and look at that bench bend. It's going to be awfully tough to knock him off of that thing.
Hey, we robots are happy now.
Here comes little Melissa Sue Anderson, one of the daughters of NBC's Little House on the Prairie.
Shouldn't you be home in bed?
She doesn't have a great arm, but during practice, they pick the ones with a good control, and she shows why she's on the ball club.
Third point for NBC. Oh, too bad. So it's CBS 6, NBC 3, ABC 2.
I came all the way to San Diego to see you in Romeo and Juliet, so be kind. Okay.
Tim Matheson, star of NBC's The Quest. What a career he's had. This is the way you usually see him, playing Quentin Bodine in The Quest. But you've seen him for a lot of years, a regular, on past shows like Bonanza and The Virginian. As a kid, did voices for cartoons, kids' shows. 6'2 now, 170 pounds from Glendale, California. Loving what he does, acting for 13 years, but with a sense of where he's at.
All right, folks. Hollywood.
Just Hollywood.
Oh, it's great fun. You know, we're chewing tobacco and riding horses and just playing cowboy all the time. It's like every kid's dream, you know. We were talking about that. I mean, saving the girl, riding out of town, beating up the bad guys and jumping on our horses and taking off. And it was something I did every Friday night when I was a kid, you know, and except Friday and Saturday night, always playing cowboy. And here we are getting paid for it. It's great.
He missed his first two throws, Reg. And there goes the third.
You can play cowboy, but not baseball, fan. Now everybody gets into the act.
So that's 3 points. Look at Gary Berghoff, Radar, and Mag. He smashed the target to show the bench could open. But John Shuck was prepared. Earlier, I asked Gary what he thought of the competition.
Hey, listen, this is probably the greatest concept in team sports that...
What a character, Reggie. What a nut. Jimmy Walker getting into the tank now. He loves fun, but I asked him how he got into the business.
You want the full true story?
Yes.
The full true story started in New York, and I was in what we call a SEEK evaluation program, which is Search for Education Evaluation and Knowledge, which is a poverty training program in New York to send kids who have not graduated high school and upgrade their academic abilities to college. And I was in there and I was writing creatively, hopefully, in my head. And I started doing stuff and people thought I was very creative and I started standing up doing comedy. And from there I just started doing a lot of little clubs and stuff like that and worked across the country. And then the great master blaster, the old Mighty Lear, saw me on television on the now defunct Jack Parr show, which is on ABC. And he liked what I did and here we are.
Jimmy tests new material at a place called the Comedy Store.
Going on unemployment situations. You ever notice when you go to unemployment office, they always ask just dumb questions on unemployment application. They always say, "Will you accept work out of your field of endeavor?" I always say, "Work is out of my field of endeavor." You're talking about. And the lines at the unemployment office, they be so long, reading around the corner, going up and down hills and valleys. There's always a guy at the end of the line complaining. There's always a guy at the end of the line saying, "Hey! How come this line ain't moving here? Come on, man, I got things to do here today. I gotta go to work." I always say, of course the line isn't moving. That's why it's a line. If it were moving, it'd be a parade. Something else. Dangerous. And some people, and I work for a long time, I stand in front of this old black dude there and say, "What was the last job you held?" He said, "Slave." Had the nerve to ask him, "Why did he leave?" Dangerous. And black folks be staying on the line so long, we forget what we came there for. A brother gets to the front of the line and says, "Two tickets, Temptations concert?" It's all right. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, sweetheart. You're looking all miffed and everything. You expect to see Sherry Lewis up here tonight?
On the serious side, I asked Jimmy what his ultimate aspirations are.
I feel that I'm going to be probably one of the first black TV producers in this business. It's a thing that I don't know why it hasn't happened, but it just hasn't happened. And I think I'm going to be one of the first, if not the first, I mean, to do like other than your own show, like Flip Wilson does his own show and he's producer of his own show. I mean to do other shows besides your own show. I think I will probably be one of the first, if not the first, to do that. And that's my ultimate thing. But I won't be doing it as a black man. I'll be doing it as a human being. Mm-hmm. And hopefully the quality will be good enough to keep us on the air because we're good, not because I'm black.
Right now, Jimmy's ultimate goal is to stay on that bar. CBS has 6 points, NBC 3, ABC 2, the American Graffiti Kid, the star of Happy Days at ABC, Ron Howard, with good control, Reg.
Good control, and he comes out of the stretch. He must have a runner on base.
Two in a row. That's right, four for ABC.
He hit it hard, but it still didn't come off yet. Woo, he went for broke.
Well, it's up to Captain Gabe Kaplan now for ABC. Oh, in attendance among the spectators, television star of 3 decades, Dick Clark. Now, if Gabe can hit it twice, ABC ties CBS.
All right, Gabe, hit it.
Hey, Walker, ready?
The
Jewish Nate.
Hockey stick with an afro.
Hockey stick with an afro. Thank Eric Cohen for that line.
He's got to connect with these last two, Reg.
He's a little off on his control in his form, Howard. Good teacher, but I don't know about a baseball player.
Gabe choked in the clutch.
Nice try, Kaplan!
Touch of the carnival with precision throwing. The rules are simple. Hit that target, you get a point automatic. Hit that target hard enough to dislodge the man in the cage and send him into the water tank, you get 3 points. But in the Battle of the Network Stars last November, nobody could do it. Robert Conrad right there is with me now. Remember, Robert, nobody could do it.
Never. And it was hit very hard by Kevin Dobson. I'll never forget it. It didn't move. I didn't move.
Even the slim J.J. Walker
hit
it.
That's true. But Dobson throws a very hard ball, and it cannot be moved. That's the problem with him.
Nobody went in. The whole of the competition the last time around, remember?
Maybe no one was strong enough.
Well, I'm going to tell you something. It is not that hard, Robert, to dislodge the man in the tank, to dump him right into the water. I will prove it right now, because my youthful colleague, Bruce Jenner, is in that tank. No, of course, way, the Howard. World's greatest athlete. You really understand.
No way, Howard. That's why I agreed to this. I knew you couldn't hit it. You can't hit the broad side of a barn.
I couldn't, huh?
No, you can't hit that thing.
Just watch.
Only one throw, now. Wait a second. You'll never hit it.
Uh-huh. Goodbye, my friend. No. You're not Mark Spitz. You've had your last hurrah. You can't swim.
I must shake your hand on that one, Howard. I didn't think it was possible.
All right, on with the baseball throw.
You should retire now because it's the greatest thing you ever did in your life.
Fun is fun, but Al Linden is going to find perhaps that this is not so much fun. Al Linden of Barney Miller. And the stars of shows on NBC go first, Gene Seymour, the first to throw. Nope. Gene Seymour, who couldn't connect in her try. A big raw for big Dan Haggerty.
I want the English one again.
Uh-oh. Did you see that? That looked like it hit the bar instead of the target. It was enough to send Linden into the water, of course. But there might be some controversy about that because he did not seem to hit the target. Nonetheless, he's taking his bows, and why not? Linden already wet.
Are you sure this is the way Lloyd Bridges got started? I would just like to remind you, sir, that you may end up in the 12th precinct one of these days.
An allusion, of course, to where Barney Miller's hangout is. Now let's look at this in slow motion. Remember I suggested that... No, it did not hit the target. We'll have to get a ruling on that later from Commissioner Rafer Johnson. No question about that one. Square hit of the target. That's Loretta Swett of MASH, of course.
My mother always told me cleanliness was next to godliness.
Are you warming up?
Whenever you're ready.
Never I'm ready. See, last year I wasn't in this event.
You're going to be in it this time.
Robert Conrad is relentless.
Hey, you're tensing up, Bob. You're tensing up. Now take it. Baby, just lay it right in
there. All right. Row number two.
Square hit. Down again goes Hal Linden. He knows what it is to get dunked, not once, but often. He's an exceptional man and an exceptional actor. In 1971, for his performance in The Rothschilds, he won a Tony. But he knows what failure is, too. He's had his ups and downs. He expresses as well.
Having gone through it to the depths that I went through it, and having risen above those depths, one develops a kind of inner security. As if I've been unemployed. Some of my best friends I made on the unemployment line on 91st Street in New York. You know, we used to go every Thursday morning, walk our dogs together. Sure, I've been through it. And it's the thing that says to you, forget it, give up, and do something where you'll know there's a check coming in every week. But then one day you wake up in the middle of the night and you look at yourself and you say, you know, I know my business. I know what I'm doing. I have a product that is unique, and when you get that kind of inner security, then you don't worry about somebody ringing you on the phone, because you know it'll happen, and it does.
What you have to worry about right now, Al, is this fellow, Kurt Russell, the former pro baseball player, because he's got some arm. Look at that, square hit. Down goes Linden. And the people who are stars of shows on NBC are really loving it.
With a performance like that, Hal, it's lucky I have my own series.
Hey, Pagoda, star of Fish. Again. By this time, it's Linden who must feel like Mark Spitz. But he takes it all with great good grace. He really does.
Ray Friend, now that the team of stars whose shows appear on the NBC network have completed their throwing, I understand that you have made a ruling with regard to Dan Haggerty.
Yes, the first ball that Dan threw that dunked Hal Linden was definitely down the bar about 3 or 4 inches, so he did not hit the target.
In other words, then the 3 points originally accorded to him are now disallowed.
Right.
Much for that. Now Dan Haggerty of Grizzly Adams is in the cage. Marcia Wallace. What's this? She is funny. And so is he. Baseball throw is really a fun competition.
Fire it in there, honey.
Nope. That encourages Haggerty. No luck for Marshall. Haggerty grows secure.
No, no, no!
Well, he's got to worry about this fella. Wild pitch. Remember, Kevin was once offered a pro contract. Good hit. In goes Haggerty. He almost displaces the entire tank. We'll be back with more of the baseball competition in just one moment. Way to go. Simpson, Bruce Jenner, the challenge of the network stars, and Rob Reiner aiming to get Dan Haggerty. But no, Rob misses. Haggerty loves it. As for Reiner, well,
fantastic evidence yes. of futility for yes. a man who was a professional pitcher.
Professional pitcher, and now professional cretin. Thank you very much.
I'm so sorry about
that. Oh,
Ben.
Well, listen.
In front of all these people.
Got them all tied up.
And Haggerty, hey, look at him over
ball.
There.
Go ahead, take another ball.
That's it. That's it. Congratulations, Rob. That's it. Reiner did it in the long run.
One looks at that burly body of Dan Haggerty's, doesn't remotely suspect that he hasn't placed within him the kind of sweetness and sensitivity that he truly possesses. He truly is Grizzly Adams, off the screen as well as on. He has spent most of his life living with and training animals, loving them. He was married at the tender age of 17, two children.
That's a boy. That's a good boy.
Purchased 80 acres in Malibu Canyon. They had to build a ranch. Once again, unlike this on location, to have his own set of animals in the canyon on the ranch.
I have a great wife and two beautiful kids, and she's been really great for me. I'm kind of, I'm always flying up in the air, and she's kind of my ballast. She holds me on the ground, and it's been good for both of us and my kids. This is great for my family. Meet a lot of beautiful people, and I just feel very lucky to be out here, and I'm grateful for my kids that they can grow up and meet a lot of nice people.
In this kind of atmosphere where the divorce rate is colossally high, what is the secret to holding a marriage together, especially when you began at such a tender age?
I think that's the secret. If you're going to go into anything, you might as well go into it full force and see it through, and there's no way that you're ever going to marry somebody and live with them and not bang heads back and forth. And I think if we both give one way and she gives the other way, I think that we do real fine. And she's a beautiful woman. She's been awful good to me, and I couldn't do any better. I can't speak for anybody else, but I think if you just put your teeth into it and ride it out, I think everybody would do a lot better.
Mike Farrell is now in the tank. Now up comes an all-around athlete, Richard Hatch, southpaw thrower. Another one of those with a real good arm. As you can see, good all-around athlete. Good hit. Down he goes.
Lucky shot.
One out of two for Hatch. Ronnie Howard, another good thrower. Happy days.
I knew you when you were a little kid, you know. Be nice.
But that's weird. That time, he didn't hit it hard enough to down him. So it's 1 point, not three. No question about that one. Ronnie Howard digged the job. And look at Ronnie Howard's parents. They're really thrilled at Ronnie's performance. Why not?
Now the baseball dunk is Frank.
Well, Howard, they said that last year you hit this on the first shot. And I'll tell you one thing, I'm not taking any chances this year myself. So here you go. Goodbye, Bruce.
Bruce Jenner knows what it is to be victimized, to go into the soup. Quickly, the rules. If you hit the target and the victim is dunked, 3 points. Hit the target, but the victim doesn't go down, only 1 point. Now let's pick up with Penny Marshall.
Look at those pits.
Good shot. And down went Jamie Farr. Jamie Farr of CBS and MASH. 3 points on that throw for ABC and Penny Marshall. You know, the same thing happens when you see it in slow motion. No change at all. Except about Jamie Farr. Quite a guy. At 17, he played King Lear.
Go ahead, I got soap in here.
Billy Crystal. That you could expect because Billy, of course, once had a baseball scholarship, wanted to be a professional baseball player.
All right, Crystal, see if you can do it again, you little twerp. Keep it up, I'm signing you with the Morris office. Come on, Crystal, daddy-o!
He didn't even hit the target, and Jamie Farr went down. Call that wind velocity or something.
What the hell is going on? He didn't even hit it. What are you doing over there?
As we look at it closely in slow motion, you can see he didn't hit the target. No points accorded to Billy on that throw.
One of the Hardly boys.
Marcus Stevenson with an errant.
Out of the way, Sean. Easy does it, Sean.
Down goes Jamie. He was calling Parker Stevenson Sean because of the other Hardy boy, who of course is Sean Cassidy.
I could try out for the man from Atlantis.
What a versatile actor Jamie Farr is. Remember Sidney Poitier in the Evan Hunter classic Blackboard Jungle? There's Jamie Farr, who played Santini in that brilliant movie. Now it's Cheryl Ladd's turn. And Jamie Farr went down on his own. Neither did we, Jamie. Cheryl Ladd. She is, of course, Charlie's newest angel, facing the big challenge. And she is an immensely serious young lady. As a young child. And when you talk to her, you know she's got a sense of where she's at. Let's meet her. I remember seeing you on a movie set once in Orville, California. I had the feeling you were pretty discouraged and maybe ready to quit.
At various times ready to quit, I think, over the 7 years. But it had been a dream for so long, and it had been something I wanted to do for so long. And getting myself out of South Dakota was a major step. You know, there were a lot of people there who said I would never be and never do anything. And a lot of people who were encouraging. And it took the combination of all of those people that got me here, and that, you know, the people that said I couldn't do it.
How much help have you had from your husband, David Ladd, after all, the son of one of the greatest of all Hollywood motion picture stars?
Oh, enormous help. I mean, he's a wonderful person, as you know. He's very together, and he's been in the business for 20 years.
I've been like on a roller coaster ride. I've been up, I've been down, I've been up, I've been down. But that's the business.
And that's all I knew. I figured, you know... I got to tell you that when I was making pictures as a kid, I figured that's what every kid did during the summer. You know, they went off and made a movie.
We have both, of course, in our careers, been at various times ready to toss in the towel, ready to say, forget it. Who needs this? It's not fun. But we never did it at the same time. It was either David who was depressed, and I was saying, are you kidding? Or I would say, oh, I can't do it. Let's just go buy a little store somewhere and have 12 kids and just... But it never happened at the same time, so one of us always pulled the other one through the depression and got the other person fired up again about it.
Another facet of Cheryl's talent, she can sing, too. From Beauty to the Beast, Victor French. Big Dan Haggerty, NBC captain, winding up the baseball competition. He's going to have to throw lefty, not righty. He's got that injured hand.
Now don't choke. Just don't worry about it. Just choke. Just
I'm calm. You ready?
This is Dan. I'll pitch up with a pair.
Lefty, righty, it doesn't matter. Big Dan happens to be ambidextrous. And as we watch again in slow motion, the baseball competition at an end. ABC wins with 18 points, 9 for CBS, 9 for NBC. Thus, the present cumulative scoring total is of events as you've seen them up till now, ABC with 100. And Bill Devane just warming up, getting ready for another fun event. The score at this point in the competition reflected there. ABC and NBC tied for the lead, 75 ahead of CBS. Well, the music tells you something, but no, it's not Dodger Stadium and it's not Yankee Stadium. What it is another scene set on the Pepperdine University campus as we get ready for the baseball dunk event. And we've got a guy here with us for this event, as he has been for all of the others in point of fact, whom you're all very, very familiar with. There he is, Sparky Anderson, the Cincinnati Reds manager. He's calm there, not always so. Look back.
There's no way that he tagged it. There's no way possible he ever tagged it.
Well, that was Sparky Anderson in the 1970 World Series. He's our commissioner for this whole Battle of the Network Stars competition. Each contestant in the baseball dunk gets three throws. If they hit this target, but not hard enough to cause it to dunk the occupant, they get 1 point. If they hit it hard enough to cause the occupant to be dunked, they get 3 points. And Giffer, this is a lot of fun. I've been through it.
It is. You know, Patty looks awfully lovely up there. Unfortunately, the aesthetics will change just a little bit because the captains of the three teams will be up there. And, of course, we might have a little vengeful throwing. Sparky Anderson has told us he hasn't seen any great arms, but nevertheless, we've watched some pretty good hits thus far. You, and by the way, you wouldn't dunk Patty.
I will not see that young woman humiliated.
Oh, no, Coach. You don't do that to a pretty thing like this. She still comes up smiling, Patty Klaus. Well, a rather graphic illustration of how it works. Oh, now we know why Mrs. C. Emmy travels with the coach. What a leading man you would have made. Ready now. Gabe Kaplan will be in the tub, so to speak. He'll go up first, representing the ABC team. He's captain again, sitting on that precarious perch. And he never does anything simple.
He's a terrific guy. He's a great sport. He's got a line for every situation, a gesture.
How about this? Great star from some rather humble beginnings, Howard.
He was once a busboy in a New Jersey hotel. Lakewood, New Jersey. And a long way.
Quick flex, and now the approach to that perilous perch. Meanwhile, on the mound for NBC, Bill Devane.
And this guy has a good arm. We watched him closely in the warm-ups. He's a good athlete.
There's no seatbelt here.
Again, free throws.
Look out! Look out! Ready? Look out! Take it easy, Bill. Aim good.
A complete miss.
Take it easy, slow.
1 point for that one. He hit it, but not hard enough to dunk Gabe.
All right, fine. Oh, and there he goes.
Oh, what a terrible feeling you get, as I've had it done to me in that very tub.
4 points now as we look at Gabe Kaplan go down. Bill Devane, 4 points for NBC.
Well, you
came up smiling.
Talk about ignominy. Here's Bill Chat.
He's a good athlete, Howard. I skied in a race with him.
Versatile fella, and of course, an exceptional actor.
There's a miss. Second throw coming up. You have to hit that target rather firmly if he's going to drop Kaplan. Another miss. Final throw.
Well,
not enough.
He was off center, as you can see, and he picked up 1 point together with Bill Devane's 4. That's a total of 5 thus far for the team of stars on NBC shows. As we took another look at Shatner there, you mentioned, Frank, that the man's a fine skier, that you've raced against him. He's been fine in everything he's ever done. He goes back so far, and there are some of the vital statistics on him. But the thing about him was that early on, when just a child virtually, he knew he wanted to be an actor.
I was born to be an actor. At the age of 6, I remember being in a play that moved people, made them cry. And from, that's a vivid childhood recollection. And from that moment on, I never was interested in anything else. My schoolwork suffered as I did extracurricular activities at university. I was involved in so many theatrical events, the college musical, the college theatrical productions, the television and radio things. And I put myself through college by performing in professional radio in Montreal. And when I left college, I had a business degree, which got me a job as an assistant manager in a theater. I was a very bad assistant manager, so I was fired. I was hired as an actor, and I've never done anything else.
Did you intellectually enjoy playing Captain Kirk in Star Trek?
I find the part I'm trying to play, I'm in the midst right now of performing in what they call Star Trek the Motion Picture. It's a multi-million dollar production by Paramount. It should be out in Christmas of next year. I am trying to play, as I've always played the part, as I, Shatner, would have ideally liked to have reacted in a given situation, given that kind of danger. How would I ideally like to have reacted, given my attitudes and human failings? How could I have fought my failings and performed in a noble way that Captain Kirk has to in order to save the world from destruction? So that's the way I'm playing him, and it's rife with problems. How to play a typical hero with problems and yet make him acceptable. And it's a challenge, and I find it interesting. I find it intriguing.
Interesting. Intriguing. Two words that describe Bill Shatner. In point of fact, Frank.
All right, we're ready now for Bob Conrad. And Bob Conrad is some competitor. He's the final member of the NBC team, and he goes right at Dave Kaplan.
I don't see a word coming out of Sparky Anderson. I've seen the Reds pitchers throw something like that.
Remember, you can run, Gabe, but you can't hide.
Joe Louis and Billy Cobb. Bring back the memories, Bobby.
And you can't throw.
They've really been at each other over the years.
Still anonymous. In the first battle of network stars, the two were at one another time after time. Once Conrad protested and the two had a race off.
Take your time. Concentration, very important.
Final throw. Oh, and he gets a point.
So that's a total of 6 points in the baseball dunk competition for the team of stars on NBC show. But there's more to come in this event.
Hey, Jacques Cousteau is filming a special down there.
Stevens getting his team ready for the baseball game.
Relax, right? Okay.
A confident, poised leader. This is one event he thinks his team can win because of what's gone on before in the baseball dunk. When he was about to go into the tank to face the ABC firing line, he put on this scene with Lou Ferrigno. Would you believe that comparison of muscles, Gif?
Epitomizes the before and the after.
Now he takes off his sweatshirt. All of this, you know, happened before he went into the tank to face the ABC throwers.
They look like bookends, Howard.
Not the kind you'd expect in an NFL offensive line. But he got into the tank, and ABC only scored 2 points. That one there by Dick Hatch, and this one right now by Billy Crystal. So, ABC had 2 points, NBC got 6, and that's why McLean Stevenson feels that his team can now finally win an event. And the man in the tub gift, Bob Conn.
Make up! Make up!
Constant chatter, and he'll hassle the whoever's throwing that ball.
In the meantime, they've sidetracked Timmy Reed. Let me talk to him and find out why he's not in this event.
Timmy, you're not in this baseball dunk. What are they doing? Saving you for the big ones?
Well, I asked them to put up some school windows, and they wouldn't do it, so I said I'll stay out.
Were you sufficiently humiliated by your performance in the kayak?
Very much so. I hope my son isn't watching. That's my... Oh, it was horrible. See, we don't go near water, so I wanted to stay out of that.
So what events will you be in?
We'll be doing a 3-on-3 football and a little relay, and maybe the obstacle course.
What a good guy that Timmy Reed is. So for that matter, Giff is Bobby Conrad. Despite all the combativeness, he's a good sport. Okay, Patty Klaus will be leading off with a group of stars on CBS shows. And let me tell you something. This girl can throw a baseball. Again, remember her in the warm-ups, Giff? Good accuracy. Good delivery.
I didn't watch you throwing much, but I remember it.
Look at that. How about that? 1 point, Patty Klaus and her team. Told you she was accurate.
Oh. All right. Little lower, Pat. Little lower.
She just missed on those last two, but she did wind up with 1 point on her 3 throws for her team. So CBS is still very much in the running. You know, Patty Klaus, who's in flying high, has done a lot of running in her life, too. Running after a career. And this is the time to meet her up close and personal.
I didn't want to come to Hollywood to be in series. I didn't want to go to New York to be a model. But, I was working on my master's and modeling part-time. It's good money even in Texas. And I was turning in some vouchers one day at the agency, and Wilhelmina's husband, Wilhelmina's an agent in New York, was there, and he said, well, why don't you come to New York and try it? So 2 weeks later, he'd written letters and called up the agency. He says, Pat, come to New York. Anyway, I ended up staying. I discovered it was big business. You know, it's good business. I was more introverted before I went to New York. I guess it was my way of dealing with a new situation. That part of my personality, which was all, you know, bouncing off the walls, bubbly, outgoing, just came out in New York. I don't mind that part. I like it. So that's probably what made it easier to do this, because I play a character that's always, you know, bouncing off the walls. Das ist dein dumb dog. I have a very quiet lifestyle, I think. I'm not a disco person, although if a group of people, my friends, went to a disco, I'd enjoy it thoroughly. I love to dance. But I don't make a point to go to clubs and discos. It's not my way of living. All my growing up years, I was the student. I concentrated on being the student, and I didn't develop anything else. Now it seems like I'm going through a period where I'm learning about personality, just being outgoing. Hope I do. I should dye my hair red. Then I'll learn something completely different.
No, I don't think she should dye her hair red. She looks pretty good the way she is.
She shouldn't touch a thing.
Valerie Bertinelli coming up for CBS's team in the baseball dunk.
Hey, Valerie! Valerie! Here!
That's right, Valerie. Don't take it from her.
Everybody looking. Forget about me, Valerie.
Wait till he comes out of the cage.
Oh, Valerie's falling apart. Yes.
Final throw now, Valerie.
That's a line.
Oh, he has her all upset.
And Conrad shows the agony there. So that's another point picked up for the CBS group. They have 2 points. And they're closing in on NBC in this event. They've got a shot. Two more to throw. And one of them is this fella, Lou Ferrigno. He's enough to frighten. Look at Conrad. Look at that, Frank. He's getting out of the tank. He doesn't want to face Ferrigno.
And you can't blame him. He probably thought Ferrigno might miss that target, hit the tank, and throw the ball right through it.
No, had enough. He gestured toward Ferrigno. Now watch this.
What a fun man. He really is.
This is a nice young man, this little Ferrigno. He's a good kid, as gentle as he is big. Sent him into the tub. Broke a piece off of the target. See that? McLean Stevenson goes up and picks up.
Conrad wasn't ready for that. I guess you can do that when you're hanging around with Caden.
I tell you, McLean is sore. I got to get into the middle of that situation.
Commissioner, what's the points?
Okay, what points allocated for that?
Oh, just one, because look at where it hit on the end. It didn't have the strength when it hit the impact.
So that even though the target itself was
even though it tore the target up, that's what Max Hardy, I know, I know, I would love
it. I think you did. No. You died on a fan team.
No, truthfully.
Well, let's take another look at that one, Jeff. You'll see what he hit.
He did hit it on the edge. Ooh, and this time, back to live action. Another point.
So they're very much in the thick of things now. They've got 4 points and another throw for Luke. That one misses, but look at him! And Conrad was ready. Good anticipation. 4 points to CBS, and LeVar Burton is coming up. But let's take now a closer look at this deeply sensitive and fine young man, Lou Ferrigno. Nobody ever dreamed he'd grow up to be like that. He got that way through tremendous work and dedication. Mr. Universe. And he used it as a stepping stone to still another career. But that's when they didn't think he was going to be very big at all. A baby picture. And in there, isn't there a resemblance to Jackie Coogan? And then, starting to grow up. And now, the new career. The Incredible Hulk. This is the way Lou Ferrigno reports to work every day. To begin a makeup process that is a positive ordeal. Takes an hour and a half to 2 hours. To make him up for his role as the Incredible Hulk. In the long run, it only takes him 20 minutes to get all of the makeup off. But watch closely, and fascinatingly, you'll see the changes in his face as each stage of the makeup takes place. Right there, a head mold. And then, the beginning of the green makeup, which is not paint, not at all. It's a kind of play. And each successive change shows the change in his character. Until finally, he emerges as what you see on the home screen as the Incredible Hulk. He has worn this makeup, those are false teeth, of course, in 135 degree heat. And he has endured. And here's one fine human being. Now here's Frank with another.
You've got two to tie NBC. You need 3 points to win. You up to it?
I'm up to it. The question is whether to go to try and knock him out for 3 points or go for one-pointers each time. I don't know. It's a tough decision.
Kind of an emotional one. Do you want to see Bob go in or do you want to go for the win?
I'd rather go for the win, but at the same time, I'd love to see Conrad in the drink.
You're up. You need 2 for a tie, 3 for a victory.
All right. Thanks.
Good work, Giffer. NBC with 6 points, CBS with 4, ABC out of it with only 2.
I love you, LeVar. I love you.
He'll suck you in every time, Conrad.
The pressure right on LeVar Burton.
You can do it, LeVar, if you try.
LeVar, don't choke, LeVar. What's the line?
Oh, he did not throw like Ron LaFleur on that.
We need this win.
What's the line, Spark?
I'm pesky though. I got a lot of kids, man. Got a lot of kids. I need the money.
Now, Howard, he's going to have to dunk him. But CBS is going to pull it out.
I think Conrad's gotten to him.
This is it.
Makes this, CBS wins if he can dunk him. So that's it. The baseball dunk competition is won by NBC. CBS is second, and finishing third, ABC. Bob Conrad gets out of the tank, and I'll tell you this, ABC, which had been neck and neck.
The baseball dunk is simple. Stand on that white slab back there. You get three throws, five contestants to a team, two women, three men per team. You get the three throws, the object to hit that target. Hit it, but not hard enough to dunk the prospective dunkie who's in that tank. You get 1 point. Hit it hard enough to cause the dunk. You get 3 points. And remember, the job in there is not just to sit, but to needle the tosser, to divert the tosser's attention so that the projected target will be missed. That's it. The baseball dunk. Let's go. One added point as Bob Urich gets ready. We've got a new twist in this event. Each thrower is able to select the dunkie from a group of four members of the other two teams, and Bob Urich has selected Kathy Buck. The thrower stands 18 feet from the target. Kathy Buck has with her her little teddy bear, little toy. Not really a toy, of course, just something she likes to have, especially for an event like this.
He does it, Robert. Don't hit her teddy bear. Don't hit her teddy.
Easy,
3 points. And it didn't take long for Bob Urich. That tank is cold. I'll tell you, I tried it. Have a look at it. Slow motion. The sudden realization of her downfall registered in her eyes. Second time around now. Two in a row for Bob Urich, a total of 6 points. As once again, Kathy Bach feels that cold water. Now Kathy's...
Help, please. Poor little guy.
She puts in the teddy bear. But that's not enough for Bob Urich. Bob Urich, who can throw. Why not? He was a football star at Florida State. And he's going back to his olden days. Ready now for the third and final throw. A hit. Urich registers 7 points, but this time Kathy Bach doesn't go down. Kathy Bach's a remarkable young woman, set out for Hollywood at age 17. Her show, Dukes of Hazzard. I asked her when she set out for Hollywood, did your parents approve?
No. But I don't think any, I mean, adults never really, when the wise people don't always approve of what their children do. I mean, they, it was a dangerous situation for a young girl from South Dakota to come out to Hollywood.
You're not the only one. Cheryl Ladd's from the Dakotas.
My friend. Yeah, she did all right too, huh?
She sure did.
And Angie Dickinson.
That's true too.
I'm always amazed when I see anybody else make it out of South Dakota. It's nice.
Billy Crystal's ready to throw for the ABC team. Picks Jamie Farr.
Three times in, right? I knew you were going to do that. All right.
You, right.
Come on, we both wear dresses. Jimmy Farr of MASH, man of high humor, a great comedic talent. But don't be misled. Within it, there is a great inner seriousness.
I can recall standing on street corners waiting to catch a bus and seeing a celebrity and hoping that someday I might have that opportunity, that chance to be one of them. And I happen to be one of the very few lucky ones.
Billy, you know I'm always... Thank you, Billy! Don't choke up, Billy. Don't choke up. Remember, I'm worse than that. Menachem Begin, and I'm worse than that. Sign the treaty, Billy. Billy, Menachem Begin, sign the treaty.
Jimmy Farr is a man of many talents. He's about to undertake a role in the old musical hit Oklahoma. Agnes DeMille has come out of retirement to do the choreography, and Oscar Hammerstein's son will direct. And so I asked Jimmy Farr what role he will play.
Naturally, Ali Hakim, the peddler. It's a delightful role. And I have a song in it I've never sung before, so...
Give us a little taste of it.
All right, I'm trying to think of it. Dum 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 dum.
Trap! Trick! Who's blinked? Ambushed! 20 minutes ago, I am free like a breeze, free like a bird in the woodland wild, free like a gypsy, free like a child. I'm unattached.
That's an accent, obviously, that I use as a thing.
You're great. Just great.
I am not inadequate.
Bob Conrad is now in the tank and praying. The selected donkey. And the man who wants to get him, the Hulk. Conrad, knock that off. Not a hit. Hit the plexiglass. I loved it when Conrad pointed to his shoulder. I dare you. That's the way he started the telecast. Got some left, doesn't it? That's a hit, but not hard enough. So the Hulk scores 1 point for his team, CBS. Now, Ferrigno getting ready for the last throw. A hit, but not cleanly, so it's just one. What is he trying to do? Conrad trying to get out of the tank. No, Ferrigno got him. He finally got him. Not fairly, of course, but Lou is happy with what he accomplished. And Conrad, well, he'll have to take it with good grace despite the gritted teeth. There's nothing he's going to do to Ferrigno, not with the disparity in size between the men. And next in the tank, Victoria Principal. Todd Bridges will be throwing at her. You must admit, at age 13, he shows excellent taste. Todd Bridges about to get ready for his third throw. He has missed once, hit one for just 1 point, and now hopes to dunk Victoria Principal, who remains poised, into the water. He connects again for a single point and thus racks up 2 points for his team. Victoria Principal now escapes the peril that had been hers. This is an interesting young woman, kind of a veteran actress, been around Hollywood 6 or 7 years, has been a theatrical agent, nominated for a Golden Globe in the Paul Newman picture about Roy Bean. She knows where her head is at.
This town is full of young men and young women who somebody told them one day they were cute, or they were pretty, or they had a little bit of talent, or they're lazy. And they decided, well, I'll go to Hollywood. It's going to be really easy. And I'll go be an actor or an actress, and I'll make a fortune, and I'll be famous. And that's all there is to it. And agents get very tired of meeting with them because there are too many pretty faces to meet each and every one and take them seriously. Beauty is truly a gift from God. It's not something you can say, I want it. No, I haven't. So I'm very grateful for it. It has gotten in the way occasionally. But I would say I am as guilty of having had let it get in the way when it did, as the people who immediately had a first impression, because I have a bust line, because I have a small waist, because I have round hips, the first impression is a body. Or if I've covered that up, the first impression is a pretty face. And so the fact that I have this gift from God that brings pleasure to people, this fact that I have a talent that I feel so happy and so full of, you know, and hungry to have more of it, it's a wonderful marriage for me. What I'm doing right now is exactly what I want to be doing. That's a wonderful place to be. And I'm going to keep growing. Why try and get ahead of myself? That's what I did a number of years back. Because I took on too much too soon.
All right. Robert Conrad, now up. As we get back to the action.
Knock it off my shoulder.
And he wants to get at Leif Garrett.
No way!
One point for a hit, but not a dunk. 3 points for a dunk. There's 1 point for Bob Conrad. Look at that guy, will you? He wants to dunk that kid so badly he can taste it. Garrett knows.
Excuse me, Mr. Conrad. Everybody's calling on the phone.
At the look on Conrad's face as he stalks back to the bleacher area. He did what he wanted to do. And he did it very well. Again in slow motion. And down goes Leif Garrett. There's been a special rivalry between the two, the older man and the younger man, since the competition began. There is Janie Kirk of Saturday Night Live.
Jane, you ignorant slut.
Don't be misled, folks. He wasn't being rude. That's just the term of a character portrayed by Janie Curtin.
There's no possible way that you can prove that. Growing is just a sexual manifestation that you have been unable to cope with your entire life. So just throw this ball, Jane. Live from Malibu, it's the cold water. Very Jane. Thank you so much. Come on, Jane, let's go. Come on, Jane, please.
Malibu, Jane.
A point for Janie Curtin, despite the needling of Billy Crystal. And as Janie Curtin winds up, I think perhaps it's time to take a look at this multi-talented actress, comedian, who is willing to take on any role in the world.
Yes, I agree.
Yvette, that's a lot of fun. And, of course, each member of the winning team gets $20,000, second place team $15,000, third place $10,000. Let's meet our commissioner. You're looking at one of baseball's greatest hitters. His name is George Brett. He's the third baseman of the Kansas City Royals. But as a third baseman, he's not that great a thrower, as you will see right now, as he missed the target for the baseball dunk. And he missed it
two ball.
Times in a row, and the fourth time in a row. George Brett is the... executed the dunk. George Brett is one of the greatest hitters in baseball, no question about it. Remember those three consecutive home runs against Catfish Hunter in the American League Championship Series in October of 78? That's the George Brett people have come to respect as a hitter as much as anyone in the game. Here he is again. George, would you be good enough to state the rules of the baseball dunk?
Yes, Howard. First of all, the object is obviously to hit the bullseye, and if you hit the bullseye, the person will fall in the water. Each player is awarded three throws, and they must stay behind this white line. If the person hits the bullseye and the person falls in the water, they're awarded 3 points. However, some girls might not be able to hit the bullseye hard enough.
And I don't blame them. You're against equal rights.
And if that happens, the person might not fall in the water, they're awarded 1 point. Now, if they hit the arm, sometimes it'll trigger the alarm, which will make the person fall in the water. Nothing will be counted on that, and they just get another throw.
Aaron Gray, beautiful Aaron Gray, has been picked by Al Williams of CBS as his target.
Will this hold me?
Yeah.
A little tentative, Billy.
I would be. It's scary sitting up there.
You should know.
Yeah, I sat up there
last year. It's cold in here.
There's Al Williams getting ready to throw. He's got a good arm, Bill.
Yeah, he's real accurate.
Why are you lousy at this?
For another turn, a good sport. A lot of badinage during this event. There always has been. It's got a carnival flavor.
You can't do an odd chicken. Look, like he's choking up. I can tell already. Let him choke. Yeah, you're choking. I know it already. See, right through that.
So Al Williams hit for two out of three, and he gets 6 points for his CBS team. Aaron Gray, a star, a beautiful star, who's making a marriage work.
You've had a successful marriage, wouldn't you say?
I would say, yes. I'm a little surprised at it myself.
Two kids?
No, one boy, Kevin. He's about 3 and a half. We've been married about, it'll be 11 years this year. It was a high school sweetheart. Got married when I was 18. He was right out of Vietnam. It was one of those things. He came home, and 5 days later, we were married.
And yet, was behind your moving out to the coast.
Yes, absolutely, 100%, which surprised me again. He's full of surprises. I guess that's why I'm still married to him, because it's still interesting. It was one of those situations where he knew I was miserable, and one morning said, cut it out, I can't stand it. What's the matter with you? And I said, well, I can't continue doing something that I don't believe in and I'm not happy doing. And he said, well, what is it do you really want to do? And I said, you know, I want to act. And he said, well, what does that mean to you? And I said, well, it means going to Los Angeles and pounding the pavement there and starting all over with a career. And he said, well, he says, I'm not happy with you the way you are now, so go and we'll work it out as it comes. And if it happens, we'll deal with the problems as they, you know, approach us.
It's most unusual for a man to do that.
Yes, I think so. He's a very unusual person. We worked hard at it, discussing what we felt about things and dealing with each upset as they came and not letting anything go for too long. Hit it right on the head as soon as you see something happening. As soon as you see the other person upset, hurt, or whatever, you say, what's wrong? Give it to me. Let's deal with it. Let's get through it.
You look back at that English leather commercial. Are you sorry you did it in any way?
Oh, no. I had a lot of fun. I was 2 months pregnant and feeling terribly sexy and very safe. So I gave it my all. No, I enjoyed it. That was a fun shooting. It really was.
Will you do it for me?
Sure. All my men were English leather, or they were nothing at all.
Tough act to follow. But Randy Oakes will follow it with one of her men, not by her choice. The man throwing at her is Greg Harrison, maybe the best all-around athlete in the competition. Didn't take long, Billy.
He's a good athlete. He does everything well.
Well, let me tell you, she's used to good athletes.
We first met in New York when you were dating Joe Namath. How long did you date him?
Howard Cosell. I can't believe you. I've been out with him for years.
You still see him?
Occasionally, I say hello to him. We're really good friends. I'm engaged to be married to someone else.
I understand.
So it's not a really good idea to be dating around, you know? I saw Joe the other day. He's working on a movie. He looks wonderful. And he seems to be very happy.
I must say, Randy, you seem to be very happy, too, starring as you do in Chips. You've got an awareness of who you are.
On television, it's like you get this instant fame. It's amazing, you know, and you really can't take it too seriously.
But, Mr. Crystal, she just may have to take Greg Harrison seriously. Look.
He's tough.
A little bit of the makeup can roll off the eyes under these circumstances. Three out of three for Greg Harris. Harrison as he rolls up a grand total for CBS of 18 points thus far in the baseball dunk. And it's a chagrin to Randy Oaks, who was helped from the pool by the man who belabored her. We'll be back.
Gentlemen, the first thriller for ABC.
Dick Van Patten about to participate in the baseball dunk for ABC. CBS has a record 27 points.
Okay, Dick. A lot of pressure. I can't be partisan, but you have to get a lot of points here.
I don't think that ABC and NBC combined are going to be 27 points.
You never know. Well, let's get it started. Who are you going to pick? You have good taste.
I will say he has good taste.
Are you kidding? Look at the pants he's wearing.
Dan Smithers, WKRP, Cincinnati. She was 16, a surfer girl at Malibu Beach. A photographer from Newsweek discovered her. She's doing a story on what teenagers in America really like. She ended up on the cover, March 21, 1966. As Van Patten looks at her, the rest became history.
Dan, I love you, Dan.
I love you, children. No!
Van Patten is not impressed by a young woman's physical appeal.
Dick's an actor, Howard. He's got great concentration.
And
it's real tough with someone who's as pretty as Jan.
That's the cover of Newsweek. That's the story we were telling you about. How it all began for her. And she's come a long way from the day of that cover. This is a very serious girl in point of fact. Concerned about a career, concerned about where she's going, and she knows she's not just another pretty dame in Hollywood.
She knows she's wet, that's for sure.
Well, Van Patten scored 6 points for ABC. Here's Bob Hayes.
Hey, Ed, are you kind of hot? Ed, why didn't you get in?
Why, Ed Asker? Why this great distinguished act?
Because he's got a great set of legs. What the heck?
Good luck to you.
Nice tan, though. Looks like the bottom of a whitefish house. We work all day. That's why we're not tan.
The man is a great sport.
He sure
is. Not a bad throw.
Hey, sucker!
Yeah, but Ed's a great competitor. Let's see if he can freak him out a little.
Wears galoshes to dance. What do you say, man?
Well, 3 points for ABC. Ed Asner, once a tackle in football. Not that bad in his earlier years, many years ago.
Ed, you should never have said that about my mother.
In the meantime, let's watch Hayes. Remember, Van Patten scored 6 for ABC.
Everybody thought it was your mother. In reality, it was your father. Funny.
He's got him a little spooked, Howard,
like
I think.
Father like son.
See? That's the whole idea of this, is to get that throw a little uneasy at the line.
Oh,
well,
we
get
to the subject of your sister.
He'd blow it. ABC with a total of 9 points. Finally, when it didn't count, he dunked Asner again. It'll take 3 people to lift him out of the tank.
They felt that in Encino, Howard. Extra shots, extra letters.
So, Ed Asner, Lou Grant will get out of the tank, and it may indeed take 3 people to lift him out of it. But how much grace, character, and dignity he is showing in this participation, in this competition. And as he does, in fact, get up, get out of the tank, and return to reality for a very brief few moments, you have to think about this man. You have to think about the richness of his talent.
Oh, it's you! Get away
from me!
Get away from me!
No, let me help you. Come on.
Get away from me!
You have to think about his sportsmanship.
Can you get it?
And you have to think about the diversification of roles through all the years. The Mary Tyler Moore Show, now the Lou Grant Show, among others. And how he spoke in a brilliant scene with Lee Chambers on the Grant Show to a teacher who had been ravaged and was afraid to come back.
Jenny, it makes me crazy that you're gonna quit. I swear to God, it makes me sick. Because you're good, and you've got to know that. So good that no one can replace you. Because if you're not there to tell these kids how important they are, to guide them, to cajole them, to kid them, to motivate them, to make them reach for more, then damn it, there won't be anyone else there to tell it to them ever. That would be a damn shame.
I thought you weren't any good at making speeches.
Perhaps the greatest success in the history of television was Roots, of which you were a part. That may indeed, in the long run, be what you'll remember most about your years in television, quite apart from Mary Tyler Moore.
I will remember it in the fact that the two reasons I did it was because I thought, well, maybe they would have a hard time getting the actors they wanted to be in it. And I wanted to be identified with talking about that subject. And the role provided a variation. I never in a million years believed that it would outsell Rich Man, Poor Man. I never expected it. And tell you the truth, I don't think your network did either.
I admire you personally very much. I mean that, and I'm not disposed to be flattering to people, as you know. I admire you because in a business that is dominated by fear, you're not afraid. You're not afraid of issues. You're not afraid to take a stand publicly. And it's not the norm in our business. Did you ever worry about rubbing somebody raw, costing yourself your career?
Only with issues that I supported outside. I thought twice a couple of times about causes I supported, but then I thought, with all the good fortune I've enjoyed, how unbelievably cowardly it would be of me if I stopped now. So that's the only time. And if everything came to a halt now, it wouldn't matter because I've had a run for my money.
And he's given this country a run for its money. A man who can do most everything on stage, and a man who's willing to have fun here. The baseball dunk continues, and Diana Canova is throwing to try to dunk Howard Hessman of WKRP Cincinnati. That's a third throw. ABC way behind CBS in the event. Having missed, she decides to have a little fun and dunks Johnny Fever, the DJ. This is a multi-talented young woman in the light of her mother, Judy. Stars in soap, and that prompted this question.
What do you feel was your best effort thus far?
Oh, gosh. I'd have to say the progression of Corinne Tate on soap. Because she's come a long way from being a nymphomaniac to an almost normal person. Something like you, Howard.
And I happen to know, Diana, that you're dating an old friend, Steve Landisberg, Barney Miller. And he was on this show, utterly inept at football. I think you can do better.
I could do better, possibly. My mother doesn't think so. She keeps reminding me. So does his mother.
You're gonna marry
him? Yeah, I might get around to it.
You don't believe in marriage as necessarily the fruition of a romance.
Oh, sure I do. Sure I do. Most definitely. I believe in the family institution, which is quickly waning in our country.
Talent. Now, back to the competition. So, Gil Gerard will be throwing at Joanna Cassidy and NBC, struggling to get ahead of ABC, both way behind CBS in the baseball dunk.
Yeah, don't worry.
No chance to catch up, or so it seems. Gil Gerard, Buck Rogers, Joanna Cassidy, Morgan Wainwright, helicopter pilot, 240 Robert.
Tune in tomorrow, folks.
Terrific woman.
Where? She's such a great competitor. She's really in the spirit of things here. She's just been having a great time.
No score there. You saw what happened on the throw. Hit the arm. It did not hit the target.
No points, but, you know, hey, you're clean anyway.
Personable guy. You know that, Billy?
Everyone. This has been the most enjoyable one I've been a part of so far.
Because you couldn't make a fool of yourself competing.
Keep talking to him.
Boy, that's distracting.
There, he finally connected for the three-point score as Joanna went into the tank.
You gave me inspiration.
That's illegal in some states, I understand.
Captain Conrad viewing the whole thing so seriously. And seriously is the right word when it comes to Joanna Cassidy being lifted out of the tank right there by Gil Gerard. Here she is playing her role in 240 Robert.
240 Robert Air, mayday, mayday, fire on board. I can't see, there's too much smoke. Sam, give me a hammer kiss.
Pull off, you're losing altitude. Pull off, Morgan.
I'll have airspeed. Control sluggish. You possibly could be the solenoid.
On the word serious, Joanna Cassidy, a serious-minded actress with a serious view of life and with good reason, two children. I asked her if she wanted the children to go into show business.
I don't mind if they do. Let me put it that way. Knowing how tough it is, I know what my daughter particularly would have to go through, but I don't mind.
What would she have to go through? Why the daughter particularly?
I think it's rougher on women than it is on men, although it's tough for both men and women. But women are a little bit more vulnerable, are up against more difficult situations as far as being compromised. Show business is not easy, as is any kind of profession like this, music or anything. But then again, my having been through what I've been through to get here has been very good for me.
What have you been through?
Hell. No. It's just been a rough period. There's been no security to it, really. I've had to struggle. I haven't always had money to pay the rent. I've had two children to take care of, besides myself. And I think that during the time you have to settle for a little bit less than you would sometime in the beginning, you know, initially. You have your ideas of how you'd like to perform. I think of myself as a heavy dramatic actress, and I've had to do some pretty silly stuff. You know, I did a show one time where I just was outrageous. They put funny glasses on me and a wig on me, and I got stuffed into a washing machine. Just really demeaning things.
You felt debased.
Yeah, but I did it, and I came through it, and I got paid for it, and I realized that that was just one of the things that I would have to go through to get to where I want to be, and I'm getting there. I'm on the stairs, you know. I'm up towards the top now, and it's okay.
You have to love that lady, don't you? But if you're Willie Ames, you're not going to love Greg Evigan, who dunks them into the tank. And with that toss, Evigan and NBC take over second place in the baseball dunk event. ABC third. CBS has clearly already clinched it with a record 27 points. Randy Oates and Bad Lane kind of enjoy things. Evigan's last throw, just for fun, really, a miss. Still another throw, just for fun, and he produced the desired result as he walked off. So, it's time, perhaps, as we look at a happy Captain Conrad, to meet our good friend, Tweaky, and get a reading on the official scoring in the competition.
Howard, would Frank do this? They told me this would be a spaceship.
Well, surprise. NBC has moved into first place with ABC holding on to second. But CBS, with that record showing in the baseball dunk, is...
...team have to be willing to volunteer to go inside the tank. And who's ever up to throw gets to choose from those volunteers, male and female, who they want to be in the tank when they're throwing. It's going to be kind of interesting to see who picks who to throw at.
Well, the first pick was made clear. Robert Hayes picked Randy Oates.
Forget it, Hayes! It's a good
football, Bob. Don't
hold the rope. Don't hold the rope. Forget it, Bobby. Forget it. Randy, you can't hold the rope. What do we do with our hands?
There you are, right there.
Hayes can throw, Joyce.
He sure can.
Randy's a good sport. She grits her teeth and comes back for possibly more.
Thank you very much.
That was a three-point throw by Robert Hayes. He's got two more throws.
Honey!
Bobby!
Bobby! 2 for 2.
Oh, gosh. I don't think she expected that.
The carnival atmosphere has disappeared. It's just no longer fun, Joyce.
What a rotten guy!
An all-time record on the Battle of Network Stars, 3 in a row, and Robert Hayes is having himself a tremendous day for the ABC team.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next thrower for ABC, Scott Mayo.
Well, we know this kid's an athlete, Joyce.
That's for sure.
Throwing at Charlene Tilty.
Seductive little ass, isn't she?
Uh-huh.
Scott, do you want to see me do the splits?
He got her in a hurry.
It's a new kind of split.
That's 3 points.
Thank you, Scott.
You're so welcome.
Howard, somebody's just told Charlene to tease Scott about Puerto Rico for some reason.
Hold on! Are you really from Puerto Rico, Scott?
Oh, evidently they think Chachi, the character he plays, is from Puerto Rico. Well, the Fonz wouldn't much care for that. They're both from Italy. They're Italian.
Scott, I love my man from Puerto Rico.
He doesn't get it either.
She just said, I like all men from Puerto Rico. I think she talked him out of it, Joyce.
I think she did too.
So, we see that in replay, and that was the ABC offense. A total of 12 points. That's a good lead at this point, Joyce.
Yeah, that's pretty good. That's a great shot. Okay, now for CBS, Catherine Bach will be the first thrower.
This is a kind of wild, zany kid who'll mislead you with her sheer beauty and sophistication of looks.
I can't even. You wouldn't hurt me. I didn't hurt you.
No, yeah, don't hold on to anything.
Yeah, I won't.
See what I mean? She'll have fun at any cost, or anyone's cost. Kent called her back. She started.
I just got overly excited.
Kathy Bach is a girl with a great ability to laugh at herself. She's a major television star now, but her idea of a touch of class is not lodged in the Beverly Hills mansion. It's in Sherman Oaks, a place called Bach Fair, a takeoff on Pick Fair, the legendary place, and this house.
Hi. Hey, what are y'all doing standing out here? Didn't the maid or the butler let you in? Oh, well, come on in. I'll take you in. Welcome to Bach Fair. This is my living room. As you can see, I'm not really ready for parties yet, but I do love to have my friends over. And this is my dining room, which is really cozy, and it's not really finished yet, but I'm making do with what I have. And this is my very favorite room in... Oh. Hold on. I knew I forgot something. Oh. Help. Well, let's just turn this off and we'll go outside. You hear? Let's get out of here.
Kathy's roots go back to Faith, South Dakota. She grew up happily there with her brother Philip. She characterizes herself quite openly as a fun-loving, kind of wild kid. She was inspired to become an actress by her uncle, entertainer Tony Vertigo. At 16, she chased her dreams, ran away from home. She explains.
My father really didn't want me to be an actress because he could see no telltale path. And my dad really wanted me to go to school and become a teacher. And I mean, Dad said, I'm not gonna be on your side. I'm not gonna help you. I'm not gonna support you, anything. And my mother said, I will always support you no matter what you do, just as long as you, you know, are doing what's the truth for you. And so I ran away from home and came out here just to see if this was gonna be the career for me.
Don't you kid yourself, Kathy had her own game plan. You'll see.
Well, I was playing steady with this boy in high school, and I was going to do 3 movies, and at the end of summer, if you know, I was going to be set up, and I was going to come back and live in South Dakota and get married. That's the truth. When I think about it, I just, oh, goodness.
Well, instead, she became Daisy in the Dukes of Hazzard, and lately... You've probably been reading a lot about her, in particular, a recent personal problem.
Well, first of all, you're reading a lot of things that I have not given interviews to. I'm sure you're asking me about my marital situation right now. And yes, David and I are separated, and no, I haven't said anything. So most of the stuff you're reading is everybody else's idea of what's happening. So...
And it's a private matter.
It's, yeah. It's very private. And it's, that's the way it is.
And well, let's keep it that way.
The baseball dunk continues at the Battle of the Network Stars. The CBS offense is in progress. Greg Harrison has already dunked Randy Oaks. This is his last throw. Let's see if he's going to do it again.
Okay. You know
what you're doing. She looked almost paranoid as she went down under. That's 5 times she's been dunked, Joyce.
Yeah, oh gosh.
Come on. Right here, Randy, I'm waiting.
I've been here for you since the last time.
Remember, Bob Hayes put her down three times previously, so hilarity was bound to leave the proceedings as far as Randy Oaks was concerned.
Bill, what are we going to do? What are we going to do?
Well, I'll tell you what CBS is going to have to do. Greg Harrison or no Greg Harrison, they're going to have to lick their wounds. He was the last dunker. They scored a total of 10 points.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm on his team now.
So they can't win it. Now, NBC will get its chance to win. Grant Goodeve goes into the tank, mimicking a gorilla. Sarah Purcell, ready to throw.
I can't skip over the line, but I can not.
Okay, Sarah. Okay, Sarah, right here.
Not up there. I don't want to.
Miss.
Whoa, a million dollars.
Oh, here goes Sarah, trying to make up for it. She got the dunk, but it didn't count because she ran up and hit it. That's been a new trick adopted in recent battle shows. Seems to work all the time. You unconsciously relax in there.
Now we'll see who Randy's gonna pick.
Oh, God.
Randy, you're sure you want to do this? I've forgiven you more than once already.
Ooh, I think her revenge will be sweet.
She looks determined, doesn't she, Joyce?
She sure does.
Seat's closed. You'll never go. Randy, did anybody ever tell you to throw a little light? Your name was
high. Oh, did you see the look she gave him? Randy used to date Joe Willie Namath. You see that? Forget it, Joe Willie. After this display, Greg Harrison and Randy Oaks may become an item. See it in your favorite tabloid. Ah, yes. True love. She's a doughty little thing, isn't she?
Yeah, I guess turnabout was fair play.
Buck Rogers. And Kathy Bach.
Kathy looks confident. She left her hat on.
Kent trying to dunk Kathy as a reminder of what Kathy had done to him earlier when he was in the dunk. Look at Scott Baio.
Down there in the lower corner. Uh-oh.
Okay, get
up. No! Oh, she was ready.
She thinks it's the young man who's supposed to fix the ropes who dunked her. Or tried to. Baio escapes unscathed.
Oh, look at him. The look of innocence.
Well, he is a great young dramatic actor.
Nothing to you, Gil.
Okay, Gil.
Okay.
Were you in the dunk when you were in the battle show, Joyce?
I had to throw, but I was never inside the tank.
Well, you're pretty good that time, but I have my good luck hat on, and I don't think there's chance.
Looks a little wet. Woo, right in.
So, this becomes a very interesting competition. NBC is now up, Joyce, to 9 points. And Bill Devane is yet to come. It's a critical throw for Gil Gerard. So they're at 9. But the captain becomes the key man, the NBC captain, Bill Devane. And suddenly, though mirth continues to prevail, there is that inner essence of competition.
Yeah, he looks ready, doesn't he?
I need a ball.
No, you don't.
I can do it if I get a ball.
He does better in October with his missiles. Quickly, Caroline McWilliams goes down under. So they're up to 12. They're tied with the team of stars on ABC shows. Here is what you just saw in replay. Caroline, her tongue about to come out of her mouth.
Oh, no.
A terrible feeling when you go down.
Boy.
Now if Devane does it one more time, NBC will win the event.
ABC also has 12 points.
Come on.
Get out there. That's Caroline. Missed.
One more chance.
So it comes down to this. He did it in the clutch. The delayed dunk. And so NBC has won the baseball dunk with a total of 15 points. And here's the scoring recap. Kathy Lee Crosby and ABC with 350. The happy Devane and NBC with dunking. If you hit the target and dunk the objective, you get 3 points. If you hit the target, but the person in the dunk tank doesn't go under, then you only get 1 point. And Ann Jillian has been selected as the object of Erin Gray's affection. Each get 3 throws, each pitch. Good hit, and down goes Ann Jillian immediately. That's a surprise, Kathy Lee.
Right on cue. Erin loving it, taking appropriate bows.
Why not? She going? She's got to get back on the seat.
She thinks she's through.
That's ridiculous.
Back, back, back.
Byron Allen is right. Back, 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 baby.
2 more shots.
You are lucky.
Well, we'll see how lucky she was.
So was I, yeah.
Erin's a good thrower. She really is. This view from behind the pitcher. Not close that time. One to go. Erin Gray has racked up 3 points for her team. That almost hit. Almost. But not quite. So that's 3 points for NBC. Captain Artie Johnson, the next pitcher. Selects Captain John Davidson of ABC, your co-star, and that's incredible. Wonder if the little fella can put him in.
Well, I wouldn't want to say that. I'd like to see him get wet. That would be terrible.
Hey, little twerp! Are you standing up, turkey?
That was not a hit. That hit the arm of the target. Not a hit.
You are so... One last chance.
Greg Evigan. Secret advice. Telling him how to do it.
Come on, turkey. Hit it in there.
Taking his windup.
I'll tell you, whatever Evigan told him, it worked. 3 more points for NBC. That's a total of 6. 3 having been registered by Erin Gray. Ah, the little fella loves it. Davidson, Quartz Tall. He also got dunked one more time by Greg Evigan, 9 points for NBC. Coming up, CBS.
Jamie Farr, the captain, is the pitcher, and is looking for a target.
Still,
who is he pointing? Howard, he's pointing at you. He wants Howard Cosell. This would be a television first. The crowd is demanding it. Can you hear them? They want to see Howard sit in that box. I don't think he's going to take no for an answer. Howard, you're going to do it? You're going to do it? No. Oh, listen to the disappointment. Well, we'll have to save that for another time.
Artie.
Right. And now, it looks like Artie Johnson is going to be the target. Captain against captain.
Now that's a proper target. I obviously would have been the utterly wrong target, Kathy Lee.
That's not good, I hate to tell you.
Oh, shut up! All I know is you took your name off the list so you wouldn't go in, and then you dare to pick on a co-captain.
I can't breathe underwater with this nose.
If you can't
breathe underwater with this nose.
If you breathe in this tank, you drain all the water. That's a good idea with you in it. If I got caught in your nostril, you'd choke to death. You know something? You're right.
They're a great pair. They really are.
Wait on. Wait till it stops. I don't want to get hurt going sideways. Okay, whatever
Jamie.
You feel like.
Well, Artie escaped unscathed.
No score for Jamie.
Yeah, maybe we better switch. Artie's a
chicken. They get a kick out of this event.
We gotta go all the way. We're gonna sink with this.
Next up is Greg Harrison.
Did you hear that? We're gonna go all the way. We gotta sink with this. So?
Artie. Behind
Uh-oh.
They're going all the way with it. Artie Johnson again. And Greg Harrison can throw.
This could be trouble for the little man.
Can you make it, Artie? I'll give you some refreshment, Artie.
I don't care anymore. Throw the ball. I want to get out of here. Wait, let's stop. Wait, let's stop. Now, wait. No, wait, just wait a second.
Hey, Greg!
No, wait! Wait a second. Now, wait. Wait a second. Now! Now! Wait, wait!
The little guy went down. Don't you love the way he comes up with that smile? Selleck now, 6 points for CBS.
Now who's he going to choose? What is he doing?
He's erasing. That's the board where you can pick your object. The person to be dunked. He erased every name but Artie Johnson's.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that poor little fella. Look at him.
Will he make it to the tank?
Sit down, Artie.
Well, you can get it.
Go get it.
That's right. Make it. All right, whatever you're ready. I don't care anymore. Life is too short.
Hey! That's 9 points. CBS is already tied with NBC.
You waste of height, you. You giant lump of meat.
Bang, two for two. 12 points, CBS has taken the lead in the baseball game. ABC yet to come.
Okay, big fella. See if you can do it this time.
And he did. That incidentally ties the Battle of the Network Stars record. 3 for 3. Bob Hayes of ABC had it last year.
Most incredible exhibition of fortitude in the Total Chronicle of American Sport. Artie, your comment.
Yeah, I want to thank all of the people at CBS for their thoughtfulness and for their incredible ability for allowing me to get into the Guinness Book of Records. Because this is a new world record, Howard, as well you know. I will go into the book with Amerigo Vespucci and Lou Wasserman.
Well, Aaron Gray of Buck Rogers will be the donkey, and Willie Ames will lead off for ABC.
Be nice, Willie. Be nice.
We are losers.
It's cold. Don't do it. Thank you. I know you're nice. I know you really love me.
And I.
And you know, Howard, that water is cold.
What's that?
Well, ABC now has 3 points. They need this event almost desperately. They finished close twice. The last two events.
I like you better in the water.
All right, go on. He's stepping out.
No, you're not.
One doesn't often see Aaron Gray like that. Now, Phyllis Davis. And for her donkey, Tom Selleck.
Little entertainment for us women here. Little screams from the audience.
A little bit of the stripper.
One more.
No. Not close at all. She's got one throw left.
Oh, she gets him. I don't think he expected that.
I don't think Tom did either. He could displace all the water in the tank. But look, 9 points for ABC, Kathy Lee. They're closing in.
They're in the running.
And Jimmy.
America.
She is a pretty good athlete.
I have bad hands, remember.
And that's the girl they want to really get back at because she killed him in the football.
I'll never catch another football for you. Oh! Oh, come on, be nice to me. I've never done anything
like that. Just missed.
Tip
the top. They gave her a point. Commissioner Gibson gave her a point, so it's 10 points for ABC. And the miss. Well, Scott Baio, you know he's always the one in the clutch. Burden is on.
They're in the swimming.
And the football.
Football.
Right at the very end there. In the swimming, as you said. He needs two hits. Two hits and ABC wins this event. Square hit. So if Scott Baio can connect on one of his next two throws, ABC will win the baseball dunk. CBS has 15, remember. NBC only got 9. ABC now at 13. So the pressure's on, Scotty kid.
Oh, no. Scott, it's real cold here. I'm going to catch pneumonia. I'm going to be able to compete.
Oh, good Lord. Totally off the mark. He overthrew.
Got a little bit of the elbow there. And again.
That's it. So Scott Baio has grown accustomed to finishing second, but not CBS. Look at them. They've won all four events contested thus far. CBS now throwing up is Greg Harrison, and CBS so far is fourth. Greg has chosen to throw at Randy Oaks. Well, to throw at the target and dunk Randy Oaks. And that's a natural person for Greg to select. It is not a Hollywood secret at the moment that the two are, shall we say, romantically inclined.
Talk to him, Randy.
No, Greg.
Later on. Yeah. Oh, Officer Bonnie Clark goes into the water.
I don't think she's too happy about that.
They never are.
Say no,
sweet, though. Note the affection he shows upon her.
He's awful cute.
Good mood to this event. Always has been. Uh-oh.
Where are you going tonight, honey? No, really, where are you going? Tell me, sweetheart.
That didn't work.
6 points. 6 points. And that's all the CBS team got. Ready to take his best shot, Scott Baio leading off for ABC, selecting Melissa Gilbert from Little House on the Prairie. Remember, he damaged his left shoulder in the football. That shouldn't affect his throwing in this event.
You don't want to do this. You really don't, Scott.
Well, she's certainly trying to distract him.
Have a happy day, yeah, right. Mm-hmm. Oh, Scott, what did I ever do?
Whoops, it didn't work. Down she goes. I think all the screams were for how cold that water is.
That's because I like you, Melissa.
Aww.
Tell her how much you like
her. I'm going to have my little sister attack you. And my mother, too. If I get sick, you're dead! Please.
Aha, success. She did it.
Got the total 3 points.
3 points so far for ABC, and the truth is he does like her. I think he could hum that song, "I've Got a Crush on You, Sweetie Pie." Look.
Aw. I do believe he's blushing.
For ABC, Melanie Chertoff.
Here she comes. This little gal is rocketing the stardom in her late night hit show, Fridays. Picked the right one.
Mm-hmm. Certainly did. I think it's a little too big to hide, though.
There we
Ooh,
go.
The best part.
Oh, my God. I did this all right.
Listen to the excitement of that crowd.
Melanie's wearing Tom's baseball cap. Detroit, if you've noticed, the Tigers.
Whoops.
Okay, rag arm.
Let's see if it'll work for Tom Selleck.
No way,
sir. Goodbye, Tarzan.
Woo! Well, surprise, surprise. The little lady can throw.
Did you see the look on his face as he realized he was going down?
Oh.
The women continue to amaze.
Mm-hmm.
I've waited for this all my life.
Make or miss, Tom.
Okay, rag arm.
Ready?
Here we go. Booga booga.
Oh, I don't believe it. Oh. Come on, Melanie.
Oh. Just missed, as a matter of fact.
Just barely.
And Jillian will be up next for ABC,
right,
which
minute,
now has 10 points because Jeff Conaway scored one.
Power! Power! Power!
All right, Angelian making her selection, and she picks Tom Selleck, a repeat performance.
Boy, the women are certainly happy with this one.
Here, Tom. We'll keep your shirt on.
Guy's got a sense of humor. Doesn't take himself too seriously. Just a good guy.
Look at my guy!
My daddy!
Okay.
I think we've got a fish on here.
We got a bigger ball.
A giant tuna.
Can you see his face again?
Open stage.
Okay, come on. Sit it down nice.
Sit it down nice and easy.
I don't believe the women for ABC.
16 points for ABC.
Well, they weren't strong in the football, but they're certainly doing a much better job in the baseball, Doug.
Finesse. That's what you said at the beginning. Finesse.
For the ABC team is their captain, Robert Urich.
This has to be one of the greatest people I have ever met in the business, Robert Urich.
Responsible for our defeat on the football field.
Revenge is so sweet.
He's going to get back at Judy Norton Tell.
I think I've been here before.
But you're not wet yet.
Get wet just getting in here. Now, Bob.
First one,
Bob.
Are you
now,
ready?
Bob.
First one, you ready?
This is very
hold
cold.
Your nose.
No, Bob, please. Bob? Thank you, Bob. That's right, now, miss. That's Bob. Thank you, Bob. Bob, I promise I'll vote for your show. Come on, Bob. I'm terrible, Bob. Come on, Bob. Get upset. No.
He did it.
He did it, and that's 19 points for ABC. That's a new team record in the Battle of the Network Stars for the baseball dunk. And even more noteworthy, 12 of the 19 points scored by the women, Melanie Georgeoff and Ann Jillian. Once again, giving vivid insight into the fact that the women are the key. So if the joy is unconfined in that ABC camp, you can understand it. NBC with a long way to go. Coming up. Points already in the bank, scored by Woody Brown. Randy Oates about to throw. She selects Greg Harrison. Who else? Megan selected her and dunked her. Now she wants to get back at Greg.
No problem.
What is she saying? He's mine? He's mine? No, he's not taking it all off.
Okay, Greg.
Let me tell you, this girl's an athlete. She can throw. We've seen her before in this competition.
She really wants this. Hey, nice going.
You know what was beautiful? A pitcher never aims the baseball, but she aimed that and she scored with it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it was the shorts on your shoulder, Randy. That's what threw you off.
Look at this.
You only can throw one
ball,
Randy.
She really wants this. Oh, no. He was successful. He distracted her.
Yes, he did. So NBC has 6 points. Now, let's see. What's going on here?
I don't know.
Come on, hon.
Come on. Oh, no. That a girl. That's a strong lady. That's an equal relationship.
Italian power.
Okay.
Now there is an act.
The next thrower for the NBC team, Michael Warren.
Mike Warren.
The little girl from the Waltons,
Judy Norton Taylor. You just have to respond to a man like Warren. He's got a magnificent personality, handsome kid, what a great actor.
Keep telling me.
If you don't duck me, maybe.
It has to be a wet affair.
Oh, down she goes. Well, they've got, certainly got a chance, NBC does. That's 9 points. 10 more to go.
You know that is?
Ah, Woody Hughes, Lynn Hughes. That's Judy Norton Taylor's husband.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm a fake.
Oh, no.
I don't know where I'm going home tonight, but...
Did you see that? Basketball push.
Yep, but it didn't work.
And, of course, my captain, though. Great UCLA team coached by John Wooden himself in a morning.
I don't think Woody wants to get wet.
NBC can no longer win it. They've got 9 points. Even if he hit for all three, they'd have 18. ABC has 19. Can we still win it? You hear him ask that? No. Nope. Matter of pride. Lucy Ewing of Dallas, into the tank.
All right, here we go.
Charlene Tilton.
Oh, good.
Don't swing.
Don't swing it. It throws off my...
Skip, you can't do it.
Three more points.
Incredible. Now that's incredible. Yeah. One more.
Skip, it's really too bad you're not funny. You'll never make it as a good comedian. You're
12 points for NBC. Hits again.
15 for NBC. Nice going.
So in the baseball competition, ABC first, NBC second, CBS third.
For CBS 6 points.
And Bob Urich's ABC team is gradually building up what may become a compelling lead. So you can understand the excitement of that group. And you can understand the joy of Mr. Urich, a great competitor.
Well, I don't believe the way the women performed, gentlemen. Urich was supposed to be the team captain, but Ann Jillian and Melanie Shawcross took over.
Are the Dunkies, prearranged names selected as the ones to be selected by the dunker to be dunked.
The first team that will be throwing is the team from NBC, and their first thrower from Flamingo Road, Christina Raines.
All right, you heard the announcement. Christina Raines of Flamingo Road leads off for NBC. Now let's see whom she selects as the Dunkie.
Not on your team.
She takes Charlene Tilton, Lee. I wonder why she selected her. Lee shrugs. He can't figure it out either. There goes little Lucy Ewing into the tank.
Now, Christina, don't hit me. I really don't like going to Fairchild. I swear I don't.
All right, Tina. Let's see what you can do. Remember, each thrower gets three shots. And Tina has already missed two. She got her. I suppose, Lee, the fish are a trifle happier at this point.
Yes, Howard, I would say there are a lot of happy little goldfish there.
So NBC assumes a 3-0 lead, and we're going to look at it again in slow motion. That's the look that invariably happens. The utter dismay at realizing you've got to go in. But never before with goldfish. 3-0. NBC in the lead over the other two networks who, of course, have yet to throw. We'll keep a running tally for you of the NBC score as we go. Fred Willard up next from Real People. Fred Willard,
who's got the body and the arm, and he selects. Well, now, that's not too bad a selection, is it, Lake?
I think that was a great choice.
For reasons that appear even more obvious as the scene develops, Donna Dixon, up into the tank. This is a scene the goldfish must love. All right, Fred Willard getting ready to throw.
Get your feet off. Get your feet off.
Fred, please just hit it.
Don't swing around.
ABC looks on. I told you he had the arm, not the accuracy, but the arm.
Well, it's for sure everybody's rooting for him. Oh, he did it.
There go the fish. We got to look at that one again. If there was any question about the ability of the fish to survive, look at her face as she realizes she's going down under. Now there can be no question about the ability of the fish to survive, Lee. Now Fred Willard coming up for his last throw. NBC now at a running total of six. Nope. Accuracy not there. So Donna escapes with a life.
The next thrower for the NBC team, their captain.
Dave Kaplan's coming up as we look at Donna Dixon leave the immediacy of the arena.
Okay, here's Gabe Kaplan deciding on who he wants to try and dock. Uh-oh, he's casting an evil eye on you, Howard. You know, I think he may want revenge on your earlier commentary on his kayaking ability.
Yes, orthopedic underwear on.
Come on, they're all rooting for you, Howard. What do you say? Get up there. Give him a break.
I think not. Kaplan is wrong. I heard what he said. I am wearing my orthopedic underwear, and Pernell Roberts, the ultimate donkey, is wearing something less than that. Roberts moving in. Kaplan taking the proceedings seriously. As you noted at the end of the three-on-three football league, Kaplan has gotten out of the kayak. He's making amends for that tragedy.
Pernell there was monkeying around, as we saw. Well, he threw the football pretty good. Let's see how he does with this.
He got that.
Bullseye.
He got it. They're up to 9 points. Roberts goes in. Look at it in slow motion. Down goes Pernell, holding the
grace.
Cap aloft, yes. Almost as if he were the victor, you know? That's a marvelous man, that Roberts. Again! So, NBC is up to 12 points as we look at that one again. NBC doing very... Look at that. How do you like that expression, Lee?
Look at the timing of the hat. Marvelous.
This is a fun event. And Jillian, after NBC accumulated 19 points in the baseball dunk, leads off for the ABC team. As she told Lee Majors, she hopes to even better her previous tie for the women's record in this event with 6 points. She is throwing and has selected at and has selected as her donkey, Jim Sickett, Howard Hunter, the comical SWAT leader in Hill Street Blues, veteran actor of 2 decades in television, all-purpose performer, a man who's got a sense of who he is and where he's at. But now he wonders about who he is and where he's at as Ann Jillian gets ready. Sickening. Lee, she is amazing. Let's look at it in slow motion.
A perfect toss here, Howard. Keeps her eye right on it. Got great form. There's a man that's not too happy.
He's got marvelous expressions. He does as much with his face as he does with his voice. Great actor. I don't believe it.
Amazing.
Did it again. Again, we'll look at it in slow motion. Lee, your observation.
Howard, she has a little luck going for her here. Not quite on center, but just enough. That's all you need. And down goes Sicking again.
Delayed reaction for Jim Sicking. And he's got to be beginning to wonder about this lady with her remarkable record in the baseball dunk. And there she is, ready to throw again. And that was a good, clean hit. And Sicking goes down for the third consecutive time. And Jillian has set a new women's record for the baseball dunk. She alone, a total of 9 points. What a beginning for ABC in this event. We pick up with the competition, the baseball dunk. In the interim, having added 6 points through the efforts of Sam Jones and Telma Hopkins, ABC has a total of 15. Captain Scott Baio to throw. Melissa Gilbert, the would-be dunkie. And Scott Baio. What a perfect hit. Down goes Melissa. 18 points in the running score of ABC. Slow motion. Look at that expression. Melissa Gilbert. Earlier, we remarked upon what a great actress she has become. Unanimous raves for every succeeding dramatic performance by this young lady. And Scott Baio did it again. So the running score of ABC as they're on their way to potentially a record score is 21. Oh, Scott wants more. There's no let up in this kid. An intense competitor, Lee, and Randy Oaks not happy with the shape of things. Melissa getting herself set again, fearing the worst. And he did it again. 3 out of 3. 9 points registered by Baio. The running score for ABC is 24. We look at it again in slow motion.
Well, here's little Melissa Gilbert. But of course, as that's what she's referred to, but she certainly has grown up.
And she takes it with as much good grace as possible. She hugs Scott, and on comes Andrew Stevens of Code Red, the tough athlete who shone so well.
She's not on the board, but she's agreed to do it. I want to try and dunk Randy Oaks.
Stevens has chosen to throw at Randy Oaks.
All right, you get the story. That's the fullness of the story. Randy Oaks, not a designated dunkie, but good sport that she is. She's willing to let Andy throw at her. I was remarking earlier that Andy had shown so well in the football competition.
It looks like Randy's doing a little distracting here, Howard.
I'm not sure that it's working with Andy.
Stevens will have no part of it.
Well, maybe it's working. So far it is. That's it. That ties the record. ABC ties the total points record for the baseball dunk event. And so the goldfish have another fling. Randy Oaks. Well, look at this dunk in slow motion. What a girl. Born in a Midwest town, population 49. Came to New York. Succeeded as a model. Came to Hollywood and has succeeded as an actress in Chips. Randy Oaks. CBS about to start throwing. Mimi Kennedy, the two of us. selecting Maude Adams as the donkey. Maude Adams, so beautiful, co-star of the movie Tattoo, about which there was so much controversy, involving the extent of her relationship with co-star Bruce Dern, who was quoted as saying certain things about the extent of the relationship between them. But right now, Maude Adams more concerned with Mimi Kennedy and the throw and the miss, which is obviously a great relief. And then that. And the hit! And Maude Adams goes into the dunk! So, the goldfish are alive and well. Maude Adams with Melissa Gilbert. I'll tell you something, a pair of major talents. Maybe differently postured, but major talents. Randy Oakes called upon again. In the meantime, CBS has gone up to 9 points. Three established by Jared Martin, three by Belinda Tolbert. The last person to go, Pernell Roberts, throwing at Randy Oakes. What a perfect hit, and down goes Randy. There had been badinage between the two, because it's common knowledge that Greg Harrison, who's Gunzo in Trapper John, is dating that young lady, and she said, I'll tell Gunzo.
I don't think this is funny. Yes, they are.
All right, Pernell Roberts, ready to go. A miss? And any more cheerful? Get the mascara out of the eyes. And the hit! Randy down under again. So CBS with a total of 15 points as Pernell runs over to help the lady of Greg Harris.
The majestic Daniel Cervantes, Howard School, I know well.
Joan Van Ark says she's going to tell us why she picked Trevanny. Randy, I'd like you to tell me why you're wearing a bathing suit.
Well, Howard, you know it as well as I do that I've never been this close to the dunk tank and not gone in. A lot. I just wanted to be prepared.
Thursday night.
What time is Doc landing on?
Don't swing.
10 o'clock Thursday night. We sat together in school.
Yeah, but that's it. That's it.
Fine friend she turned out to be.
Well, he escaped more easily than he sometimes does on Hill Street Blues. Kathy Box selects Doug Barr. Wonder if there's a reason there akin to why Joan Van Ark selected Danny.
Sort of looks like it's a different reason, Howard. You know, Howard, the only thing Doug can do is distract.
Okay,
Doug. I wonder how he's gonna do that.
Everything you can, Doug.
Everything. That's all right.
Oh, no, 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 no.
This one. I can't believe it. He fell for the oldest trick in the book.
He sure did. And he should have known better. All right, let's see if she can score legitimately.
Yeah.
Breathe enough.
We continue with the baseball dunk. CBS now has 9 points, and Bobby Walden, cut it out, Bobby. He's picking Heather Thomas as the potential dunkee. To be perfectly candid, Robert, I might have done the same thing. Heather getting ready for the possible trip into the tank. Girl who looks like that could distract anybody.
She's a beauty.
No way, sucker!
Be a little embarrassing. You should know, Randy Root.
Oh, memories. Howard, memories.
No way! No way!
There's something for Lauren.
No way!
So the smallish man from New York City connects again, and CBS has 15 points. Look at Bobby in slow motion, right on target. And this is what's always so amusing about this event, the chagrin registered on the face as one goes into the tent.
Is it possible to have a reunion with my friend?
I don't believe this. I do not believe it. A good thing she wore that suit, and she is an expert, as she's already stated, at being dunked. Randy Oaks, the beauteous thing.
I'm not gonna look at you, sweetheart. I love you, but I don't dare look at you.
Okay, Cornell. Cornell, hon. You got it, sweetheart?
Well, safe for a moment anyway.
Looking good, looking good.
Uh-oh. Destined to happen. Poor Randy. In slow motion. Perfect hit. 18 points for CBS.
Like being booked for about 10 days in San Francisco Memorial Hospital.
That's where I'm bound to end up here. Forget it, hon. Forget it.
She's been dunked more times than anyone in the history of the competition.
For the CBS team, that's 21 points.
21 points for CBS. That's their total. It may be insurmountable. It's a huge number. Based upon past battle shows. Girl's got a lot of spirit, a lot of guts, a little nippy out, but she'll survive. Coming up now for ABC, Joan Collins, and she selects Kathy Bach. Interesting little note here in the warm-up, Kathy Bach taught Joni how to throw. You think this isn't a pleasant show to work?
Come on,
Joan. Hey, forget everything I told you, Joan.
Didn't embarrass me.
I don't believe it. She's just learning how to throw.
We got another shot. Come on. Concentrate.
Great. In slow motion. Just ticked it, but got enough force behind it to dunk Catherine Buck.
Jack, it's not that bad.
I want everybody to start yelling and throw our concentration up, please.
You taught me how to do it.
I know. That's the worst part about it.
Are you ready?
I'm ready, Jack. But I know you're not, so why don't we just forget this?
Well, even with that motion, she scored 3 points. Should have used, as she used to put it over in England, a header. And Kathy Bach took one into the dunk. ABC scored only 12 points in the baseball dunk. NBC begins. So, Joe Piscopo is going to be the next participant in the baseball competition. Some words of wisdom, Joe?
Hello again, everybody. Joe Piscopo, Battle of the Network Stars. California, Malibu, competition. Exciting, thrilling, fun. But the big story, Howard Cosell. The professor. The master, the mouth. What's the story, Howard?
You started in mediocre fashion and gravitated downward from there. That's the story. You peaked out in Jacksonville, the only one in the history of the industry to have achieved that. Let's hope that you can help your team now.
Right, Howard.
Good luck, Joe.
Come on. He checks the runner.
Joe may have missed, but he doesn't miss on talent.
Concentrate.
All right, Joe, you're finally connected. And now we continue with the baseball dunk.
Shut up, Brian.
Thelma Hopkins, the donkey, and Tina Raines will be the would-be dunker. Good shot. Randy Oaks still warming out from her recent dunking at the hands of Pernell Roberts.
Well, everything's cold. I think some is cold where it hasn't been cold before.
She's black and blue.
Okay.
Now we have John James here, but this is the real fun. You get to pick who you want to dunk. Oh, he's got Christopher Norris. She looks really cheerful, right? She's ready to get wet.
Calm down.
Okay, so he's going to get three chances. Now, if he hits the target and triggers the dunk, that's 3 points. If he hits the target without triggering the dunk, it's 1 point. So let's see what happens with old cute John James. He's still dirty from the football.
Okay, John, here we are. Over here.
The only defense the person has in the dunk is to distract the thrower with their body or their mouth, and Christopher is doing a lot of talking.
Was exactly right, Debbie. No score for that. The ball hit the railing and then hit the target, and that caused the dunk and great consternation on Chrissy's part. Under any circumstances, no score. Irrepressible Debbie Allen is with me, and Dean Butler gets into the dunk tank. Helen Hunt of ABC about to take aim.
Good throw, Helen. Great.
She did nick the target, and down went Dean Butler. He had had an easy confidence. You could see it in his face until suddenly he realized what was happening as he went down. So ABC finally scores 3, John James having earlier failed to even score. Next time around, Deb.
Helen goes at it again. This is not an easy event, Howard. Women don't have a lot of experience throwing baseballs, I don't think.
Oh, I know some who do. Anyway, Helen missed. Now she's down to her third and last throw. She scored 3 points. Just missed. Not a bad effort, Deb.
Nope, and Dean is happy about that. Oh, but she got him anyway. I love it. That's great. He's a good sport, Howard.
He is. He's a good guy. Hope his show succeeds. Yeah. Now, here's Steve Collins, and this guy is a very, very good athlete. And he picks Danny Travanti, captain of the NBC team, to go in.
Oh, he's such a showman, Howard.
Travanti is something more than a showman. He'll have a lot of fun. He'll have a lot of fun in that dunk tank. But throughout his whole life, there has been a lot of struggle, a lot of hardship, and he's a man who cares deeply about his profession, cares about his own standards. Told you Collins was a good athlete. Travanti takes it in all goodwill. Look at him. Strongly built fellow, Deb.
Isn't he, though? All those muscles are so well developed. I asked Dan what he does. He said he just built like that.
He was kidding you, Debbie. I touched earlier on some of the travail that he has had in his life. This man is all strength of character. He knows what it is, as you see another hit there by Steve Collins. He knows what it is to undertake a physical regimen that would put him in the kind of condition you see him in now today. Yes, of course, he knows what it is to be a good sport, but he knows what it is to be victimized by a terrible disease, the disease of alcoholism, and to fight back from it.
Oh, they're clowning around down there now. Kevin Dawson's got Jerry Cooney in the dunk tank and invited Howard to come up and throw at him. All right, Howard. Get down, Howard. Oh, but Cooney refuses to go down. He won't let go. Howard is tough. He hit that target the first try. Too bad he's not on one of the teams.
All right.
Oh, the kid, Ricky Schroeder, tried to get him. Cooney still won't go down. He refuses. Look at Howard. He's having a ball.
Now you know about so-called athletes.
Schroeder got him. The kid got him. Oh, Ricky's having a great time. Look at him.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, Jerry Cooney.
Cooney's threatening Schroeder. That's terrific. Great fun.
So the two beauties are up in the dunk tank, both headers, and the throw by Byron Cherry promptly sinks them, but look, Heather Locklear's leg caught. Quick moment of worry. Apparently she's all right. Let's look at it again. Notice the way that left leg was caught. Fortunately, she didn't go all the way to the bottom. And checking her as she got out of the tank, she seemed perfectly all right. Only a mild scratch. 3 points for Byron Cherry, a total of 6 thus far for CBS. Debbie, I must say Heather Thomas is a good sport as Ricky Schroeder comes up to take his shot.
I agree with you, Howard. Ricky's ready. Look at it. His spirit's up. He's calling Heather back.
Good Lord. NBC throwing now. CBS out of it. 6 points as against 9 for ABC.
Accuracy rates, Ricky. Gotta hit him.
I guess that put the kid in his place, eh, Deb?
I don't think so. I think Ricky is ready to get Heather. Up! Down she goes.
Quick hit for Ricky Schroeder. Obvious that this is an advanced young man for his age, apparently in terms of sophistication, having selected Heather Thomas as the donkey.
But it's getting competitive now, too, Howard. NBC needs these points.
They certainly do. If they can win in this event, they'll be right on the heels of ABC and will have passed CBS.
No way, Ricky! No way! Hey, you want your treehouse? Look out, look out! No, no!
Kid's got a good arm.
Heather's good at distracting. Body and mouth.
Look out, Ricky, now. Ricky, now, watch out. Watch out, don't hurt yourself.
Hit it again. 6 points for Ricky Schroeder and for NBC thus far. And a thoroughly doused Heather Thomas comes out of the tank. Oh, that resignation, that look of utter resignation as she goes down. Well,
and Ricky's such a gentleman, he's going over to see that she's okay.
I wouldn't be that confident with him if I were she. He's 8 going on 28.
That's right, Howard.
Here comes another, honey, Tina Gale, the former Dallas Cowboy cheerleader, the heroine of the football competition. She selects John James. Draws the usual oohs and ahs. Remember, ABC leading in this event with 9 points, and already NBC has 6. So they're on the verge. NBC is.
Come on, Tina.
Never.
Good hit. Look at the reflexes. Debbie got rid of the cap in time.
Never say never, Howard.
Look at it again. Very quick reflexes.
Good timing. John James is something.
So already NBC is in a tie with ABC in this event. Let's see what Tina can do now. Close, but a miss.
What?
Nope. Tina scored 3 points. Again, the NBC total, the same as ABC's 9. And Dean Butler will be the final dunker. Well-built kid, too, this guy.
I want Christopher Norris up there. I want it right now.
No problem.
You don't think so, huh?
No problem.
We'll see if there's a problem or not, Chrissy.
I know how this works now.
Remember, she started competition as the donkey. Remember, Deb?
Yeah, she went down real fast.
You know. I mean, I think you're cute, but never.
Hey, this is serious now. Kidding's kidding. But this event is critical. For NBC, two out of two misses. It all comes down to this. He did it all right, his new show, Little House, New Beginning, and he's given NBC a new beginning. They are trailing ABC at this point in time. By only 25 points, they have forged ahead of CBS.
John James very kindly agreed to help me explain the rules of this game, which is very simple. If the person has to stand back here on the pitcher's mound, and they throw baseballs at this, and if they hit it, they get 1 point. If they hit it hard enough to knock the person in, they get 3 points.
Thank you, Mark. Yeah.
How'd you like me to wrap my arms around you right now?
That's okay. I'm sorry. Oh, are you all right? You must be freezing. Right.
She really didn't seem at all sorry to me. Did she to you? John Beck will be the first throw-up for CBS. He's picked Mr. T, who'll be on his way to the tank to be the first potential donkey. The stare is baleful in the manner of the late Charles Sonny Liston, but the man has a surprising sense of humor.
You'll never take me alive, you dirty copper! Huh? Hey! Hey!
Uh-oh. Morgan, I thought it'd displace all the water in the tank, especially with that jewelry.
I know. I thought it'd sink to the bottom. What's he doing?
It's a porpoise now, snorting.
Oh. Not the shy type.
Can you believe it? And I gotta get up here again? You get a chance to throw again?
Marvelous expression.
How many you get? Three? All right, somebody hook it up. Do I have any fans? Here? Man. Call it, man. My real fans wouldn't let it happen to me. Man. Man, I better switch networks.
Told you about his humor.
Oh. Oh, my God.
Well, 6 points scored for CBS by John Beck. And look at Mr. T. That's the most surprising.
With good grace.
Again in slow-mo.
Scream as he goes under.
And fortunately, able to get up. For a while, I didn't think so. It's a special kind of personality, this man. Denise Miller, up next.
Get away.
She picks Bruce Weitz, the man in the tank.
Oh.
And hits. Now we can call him diminutive.
Oh, look at that.
In slow motion. Watch this. What a marvelous catch of expression right there. The resignation etched in the face. All right, second chance now for Denise. I tell you, you've got to be good humored to go through this. As of the moment, CBS has a total of 9 points, and it will stay just that way. John Beck had 6 points, and Denise Miller 3. That's 9. Watch this kiss. She may crush Bruce. Now, here's the guy. Here's the former Trojan. You can see it. And he picked Jeffrey Scott. Remember, part of this event is to heckle, to harass the thrower.
Didn't heckle enough.
That didn't take long. Slow motion. Doesn't he resemble Burt Reynolds, though, Morgan?
Yes, he does, actually, a bit.
Not at that point, right?
Well, you don't know how Bert might have looked going in. So, 3 points for Moses.
So you don't have a time on you, do you?
Didn't work again.
The kind of athlete this kid is, nothing deters him. Here we go again. Well, you could see in his face that he expected it.
I think he knows what he's up against with Billy.
That you were a southpaw.
Yeah,
I had no idea.
Why is
he trying with a leg here?
Goodbye.
This kid is good.
Oh, terrific. But this man took it with great good grace, and CBS has a total of 18 points. They're really rolling up points in the baseball dunk. That's the 18 points they wound up with in total.
Listen, I want to thank you very much.
Revenge is sweet.
Is that your name up there?
ABC now up. Scott Baio about to select his dunkie. Meredith. Baxter.
Poor Meredith. I bet Scott is good at this one.
What a lovely lady. 3 children and...
She's in great shape.
She really is. Just
a marathon runner. Look at those legs. Oh.
Maybe she's taking the Jane Fonda courses. I don't know. But she and David, her husband, both ran, you'll remember, in the New York Marathon.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
You know, she wasn't even ready, but it didn't matter.
Caught her a little off guard.
In slow motion. You can see her.
Oh, just getting settled in.
Yeah.
She goes down.
Mm-hmm. Gotta be a good sport in this, otherwise...
Yeah. Such a glamorous job for a girl, you know?
Well, here we go again. ABC.
Oh!
Scott Baio, 2 out of 2, and quickly ABC gets 6 points.
If looks could kill.
I can only assume...
Checking out her contact lenses. That's what she's doing. Thought she'd lost them for a moment. Yeah, she has them. You heard her.
It's all right.
That's the way I sit.
By the way, she has extraordinary eyes.
It's nice when they give you a chance to get settled before they dunk you.
Oh. Scott finally misses, but 6 points... for ABC. Andy Oakes.
I'd like to see Tom walk out with his shirt on.
Yeah, I can't swim, so
Well, a guy built like this is bound to excite roars from the crowd, especially a young crowd. Is she eyeing him up?
Boy, is she taking a bead on him.
Stand back there.
I'm really
mad.
Got my
too bad. You can't hit it. Give it up.
Oh. Well, look at it again in slow motion. You can see how pleased Randy is.
Yes, she looks happy.
Look at this.
Tom looks a bit shocked.
Great, great facial reactions as they're about to go down, revealing everything about their feelings at the moment.
Well, there's that one moment when they know.
So far, Randy Oakes has 3 points and ABC a total of 9. Performance. Look at Randy go over there for the kiss. Look at that. And ABC has a total of 12 points. Scores tied. CBS, ABC, 18 points. NBC's time for revenge. Mr. T to throw. Looking squarely at Morgan Fairchild, now sitting in the audience with Audrey Lynn. Pick Morgan.
Who won this?
All right. All right.
Audrey had told Mr. T that she's not on the list of potential donkeys. Randy Oakes. You might have expected it. She's been through this so many times before. Has a competitive drive that's made her one of the most beloved people ever to appear on this show. Look at her. Could you believe that a girl who can put on an act like that came from a town in Iowa, population 62, and this is the sophistication that's emerged? We've got Morgan back. And Mr. T misses. Look at...
She's not disappointed.
Oh, I love the way that girl swivels. Well, twice Mr. T has missed.
She has spent more time in this tank than anyone else in the history of the battles.
Oh, my gosh.
In slow motion. Look at those moves.
This could be a whole new career for Randy.
Randy, come back to New York. Now, we're back at Pepperdine, and her teammate Heather Locklear is in the middle of a sudden-death dunk-off. Here's what happened. At the end of regular play, ABC and CBS were tied with 18 points each. The rules dictate a dunk-off.
Do what a woman's gotta do.
Look at Heather. She's a knockout. Players from each team take alternate turns of one pitch each. If one team makes a dunk, the other doesn't, the victory is secure. Scott Baio has already missed his attempt. And Billy Moses choked in the clutch.
I can't believe it.
I thought victory would be in the bag for CBS, but Moses choked. Well, right now, Jeff Scott up for ABC, Tom Wopat in the dunk.
I'm going to do all the things I did when I was a pitcher in the Little League.
I'm getting to like that Scott guy more and more, aren't you?
He seems very nice. Wopat will try anything to distract him.
Get the ball! Never!
That's it. Jeff Scott dunks it. Now, according to the rules, both teams are given equal opportunities to hit the target. CBS has one final chance. But first, Wopat in slow motion. Down you go. Once the name of a television show. Down you go. Now, Scott is the projected donkey. And John Beck to throw. CBS's chance. Nope. It's all over. ABC wins the event. ABC assumes a huge lead as the score.
The donkey. That team gets 3 points for such a throw. However, if the thrower hits the target, but hits it so softly that the donkey is not dunked, the team gets only 1 point. Each team has four throwers, at least two of whom must be women. And, of course, there are four people on each team getting three throws each. That's the nuts and bolts of it. Any question, co-hosts?
I don't know, Howard. Have you ever tried this?
Conrad knows very well. He bore witness to the fact that I have never missed.
Howard, I saw you hit it once. I have the highest regard for your command of the English language, but Howard, to be quite honest, I think your arm is suspect.
Howard, I don't think you could hit the side of a barn.
Honey.
Howard, I'm so sure of it. I'd go and sit up there with all my clothes on.
Jim Palmer in his prime was but a shell of me as a pitcher. You go up there and put your... I'm going to help
you. All right, okay. I'll go up there. I'll sit there. You get one throw, though, Howard. That's it. If you hit it once...
That's all I need.
All right.
Be in the water. Okay, help. Will you hold these boots, please? All right. Up you go. Up you go. Are you ready?
Not yet.
Careful.
You'll never do it, Howard. Howard, wait, please. Let me do this. How do you get on this thing?
I thought you...
Sit right down, Donna. Sit right down. Put your feet up.
Stop shaking.
She's going to be shaking. Please let me do this.
I thought you two... Oh, you want to get back at her?
Yeah, absolutely.
She stole your husband.
Husband, Ted, Gary, Ewing, you name it, whatever it is. I want to take you... No, please, I'm begging you, let me do this.
You don't want her? I'll do it.
All right, you get one chance.
One chance, and then it's your turn. All right, baby. Hands now and call it off. There you go. Look, Captain Devane, get her out of here.
I'm trying.
Mr. T!
So Heather Thomas has selected Mr. T as her potential dunkie. Remember, she gets three throws, each dunk worth 3 points.
All right. Do I get any points if she missed?
All right. We have to have a group of people here to get this guy if he goes in.
All right.
Chad, come on up here.
Look here. I'm going in and let y'all know my dolls are waterproof.
I want to get a derrick out here. I'm very serious. If this guy goes down, it'll be like looking for a shipwreck.
Look here. Just a minute before you throw. Just a minute before you go, Heather, let me tell you. Hey, now you guys back here, make sure she hit it. Don't make the thing go down like it did last year. Trying to get pointers with the lady, you know. If she hit it, make it go down. I don't mind. But don't push the button if she ain't hit it. Because I will see you when I get out the water. All right. Now. Mr. T!
What a character.
It's a good thing that water isn't any deeper. He'd sink like a stone.
In slow-mo, Robert.
He got everything he had coming to him.
What's he doing? Oh, he's got his doll. Right on the target. That protects the target. Or so Mr. T thinks.
I'm glad I'm going first because I'm the captain of my team, you know. I won't let the team know how the water is, isn't it? Don't be afraid, you know. I'm not afraid. Mr. T, you're not afraid. Come on.
3 points for Heather Thomas.
Can I get out now?
So Heather Thomas completes her chores. She scores 3 points. ABC thus far has 3 points in the baseball dunk event. CBS now throwing. ABC concluded its turn with 6 points. Martha Smith is throwing at Jill Whelan, and she's already dunked her once for 3 points. This will be the second throw. And a miss, as you see. Third throw coming up.
It's actually very nice.
That's a hit and a dunk. So CBS has 6 points in total, courtesy of Martha Smith. Not too bad. Not too bad at all, Donna. What a lovely lad.
I'm getting to go now.
Hey, man, don't you touch the wrong thing, though.
Touch the wrong thing on that?
I can't just throw there, Donna.
All right, let me get set. Let me get set first.
Tell me when you're set.
All right, come on.
I'm ready.
Nice and relaxed.
Oh, baby,
baby,
paint on.
Paint
on,
come on.
Okay. Swing
a lot.
Miss for
Joan. Oh, how they love to make Mr. T the target.
Hey, Jim, go!
Ooh, she did it. It must be the doll.
The doll, and that's why the dunk wasn't executed. Isn't that amazing? Down he went.
Nothing can stop Joan.
That doll is worse.
So, 9 points thus far for CBS.
Nothing can penetrate me. All right.
See in replay. It hit the doll squarely.
It did.
This is all right.
So can I just go up and...
Yeah. Did you get it this time?
I don't know. Now you get nice and relaxing.
No, I'm all right.
No, you're tight. Now you're tense.
I'm going to talk to Mr. T.
Well, the doll's way off on the side.
Huh?
The doll's way off on the side.
All right, that's all right. He leaning that way.
Oh,
that's all right. That's all right, man.
Joan Van Ock misses on the third throw, so CBS current total is 9.
Heather Thomas!
Andy Stevens has chosen to call Heather Thomas.
Andy Stevens picks Heather Thomas.
I wonder why.
With me, my co-host, lovely Donna Mills, and fighting Bob Conrad.
Well, I hope he doesn't dunk her. I don't know about you guys.
Why is that?
Take a look, Howard.
His mother once appeared with Bob Conrad.
That's right. That's right. I was just thinking about his mother.
I'm doing y'all a favor, you know.
Matter of fact, Andrew, you're right.
Oh, honey, no way! You know, the beautiful things I can see, I can make you feel so good. Miss it!
Hey, wait a minute. That didn't hit the target. There'll be no points for that. That'll be disallowed.
I think there's been some skullduggery going on here.
What?
Look at her.
What are you thinking about, Robert?
How beautiful Andrew's mother, Stella Stevens, is.
All right, throw number two.
No way,
a miss. Finally, a hit and a dunk. So CBS now has a total of 12 points.
Thank you, Miss Thomas.
Take this in replay, will you, Bob?
We're about to see one of America's great moments on film.
Well, so much for Heather Thomas, and there's a lot. 15 points for CBS, 6 for ABC, and NBC has accumulated 6 thus far as we pick up the action with Cynthia Sykes selecting Charles Frank as her potential dunkie. Frank looks suspiciously like a good friend of his named Scott Carpenter, whom he plays in the movie The Right Stuff. That's 9 points so far.
Oh, it's not that bad, Charlie.
Cynthia Sykes, really a lovely looking lady. A lot of class. Former Miss Kansas. Didn't know that, did you?
I didn't.
And Miss... Watch this now. Good hit. Now, NBC is up to 12 points.
I love your movie. You're wonderful in The Right Stuff.
Well, she's playing up to Charles Frank right there. And we'll be back with more of the Battle of the Networks. NBC has accumulated 18 points. And Ed Albert is the last thrower. Selects Heather Locklear as the potential donkey. Heather Locklear, who is a great, great athlete, very wonderful runner. What are you thinking about, Robert?
Is that Locklear or Thomas?
Wise guy. Ready out. This?
Take your time, brother. Take your time.
So, NBC has 21 points, CBS 15 points, ABC only 6 points, and NBC has won the baseball dunk event.
In my opinion, the most
atmosphere attaching to it, and this time to explain the rules to you, one of the most memorable names in the history of baseball, our commissioner, Bob Uecker.
Finally, the commissioner gets to do something he's very familiar with, the baseball throw. And in this case, sitting on the trapdoor or the trapeze swing, the lovely Tracy Scoggins. Here's how it works. This is really simple. This is great. All you do, 17 feet away, take a softball, throw it, hit the target, and the trap breaks in the water, in the tank, right? Okay. You hit it, that's 3 points. The trap breaks. You hit it, the trap doesn't break. 2 points. No, you get 1 point for that. I'm the commissioner this year. 1 point only, okay? If you miss this thing completely, garbage, nothing. I mean, it's basically simple. Okay, here's how it works. Simple, watch. You hit it, bang. Wait a minute. Now, it's supposed to work. She's supposed to go down, okay? It normally does work, okay? Okay, maybe I'm not hitting it hard enough. Softball, boom. Can't catch a break.
You know, this always works for me.
Some people are born losers. Yuka represents the group. See what I mean? Ready for the competition? A list of the potential donkeys. And Mark Harmon juggling to get into the act. And Mark Singer ready to throw. Cautioned by the crowd not to put on outer trunks.
Oh, yeah. Brenda Vaccaro.
Brenda Vaccaro selected as the initial donkey. Remarkable woman.
Thank you.
Remarkable actress. Great sense of humor. Really got an engaging personality.
Brenda,
She's not going to take a thing off you. Not one single thing.
Well, we'll wait and see what happens here, Howard. I'm not worried about her getting dunked. I want to see how she gets on the trapeze.
A little tentative, you.
I don't like her style already, Coach.
She's like, let's make a deal.
Nobody ever went on the trapeze more gracefully than Shari Belafonte Hawk. Do you remember, Shari?
Yes, but luckily no one was watching when I had to get on the trapeze.
Watch this.
Stupid thing, you know. This is really stupid. You want to pick somebody else?
She's a good sport.
First time,
right.
I'll never do it again.
All right. No, better take those sneakers and put them in the water.
Okay,
I don't want to put my feet anywhere except where they are. This will never work. I guess that's going right. What?
You gotta keep your feet off of
them. Don't.
There they go.
In other words, let him dangle.
Yeah, bend
so you
knee,
fall
Brenda.
Straight down and watch your back. No case of pushing back. Oh, my God. First time.
She's gone.
Second, they didn't hit. He hit the arm, though. I don't think he hit the target. Didn't he just hit the arm?
Well, you're the commissioner, you.
And that's not a three-point throw. Exactly right, Sherry. That ball hit the arm. Never hit the target, but it set it off anyway.
Well, how come, Bob, that when Mark hits the arm, Brenda gets dunked, but when you hit the target, absolutely nothing happens?
Well, I told you earlier, honey, I can't catch a break out here. You know? Come out here and catch a break, but I haven't called one yet. Here it is one more time. Watch. Over the target, and it's going to hit that back arm. And it set it off, and Brenda, yeah, unfortunately for her, had to hit the... Howard, how are we going to get her back up?
It's not going to be easy. But...
I'd like to just rest for a minute. Has anybody got a martini?
Yeah. Well, here it is again. She was ready for it. I shoes and all. Shoes and all. And that one didn't even hit the target.
Ah, she's a great sport. She really is. So you're getting ready to go to work again, Sherry.
I've seen this guy at work.
Oh. The tower.
Uh-oh. Adios. That one right on target. So Mark Singer picks up 3 points for NBC.
And Commissioner, earlier CBS had their turn to throw. Bill Devane, the CBS captain, was the first thrower. And who do you think he elected to throw at? Tracy Scott.
I understand now why Devane's a team captain, Howard.
Why?
What a pick.
I had a body like that once.
Did you?
Yeah.
I still like it the way it is, Sherry.
Thanks, Howard.
All right. Devane's first throw, down goes Scoggin. And 3 points for CBS.
Now, we're back to NBC and Mark Harmon, who was chosen to throw at Heather Locklear.
He's also chosen to help her get into the tank.
I don't want Scott Baio to know about this.
I love team captains. I really do. You guys are up all the time.
You really have their mind on their work.
This was the best assignment you ever had, you.
You got that right. Howard, if Harmon hits the target, holler at me, will you? Boy, this guy's got a great arm. He really does. He can throw. Oh, adios. 3 points. Harmon's first throw right on the money.
So NBC is now at 6 points with Mark Singer's three.
Here's that last throw by Harmon, right on the money. But before he hit it dead center. Locklear in the tank. The way this guy throws, Howard, I know he's got to hit it a couple of more times. I know he does.
Okay, Mark.
He looks like he's throwing cross seam fastballs, Howard. Three more for Harmon. That was a split-fingered fastball, Howard. Did you see it?
Yeah, he dropped it over the top of the target.
He threw it high, and the ball actually came back down. Watch this. See it hit the top of the target?
He stayed well within himself.
Stayed within himself completely, pal. All right, another 3 points for Harmon.
So, 9 points for NBC. Doug Sheehan comes up.
If I took the shorts off, we'd have to change the rating on this.
Stephanie Kramer will be throwing at Doug Sheehan.
They'd need a wide angle.
Stephanie Kramer, of course, from Puncher.
Howard, if he goes in, we may have to refill the tank.
My fellow Republicans, for what we are about to receive, may we be fairly grateful.
Oh, God.
Okay. Come on, leave
her. Shut up.
Okay.
She got her point across quick, didn't she? Huh?
Oh, hey.
She wanted to complain to the commissioner.
I wasn't looking, Howard. I had my eyes someplace else. I'm sorry.
Oh, down he goes. All right.
She had to hit it, Howard. You see it? I was turned around the other way.
Yeah, I saw it. And he did hit the target. But the interesting thing about Doug Sheehan, as we watch him go down into the dunk one more time, straight arrow, no-nonsense guy, good actor in Knots Landing, and a guy who really joins in the battle shows, has a great time of it. So a total of 12 points for NBC.
We're dying. Come on. Pace. Pace. Go.
Stephanie has one more throw, Shari.
But not without a good dunking.
So NBC has put away CBS in the baseball dunk. ABC is up next, and we'll be right back. They've already completed their turns. NBC, 12 points. CBS, 3. Ready to start, Tony Danza for ABC. And as you can see, he selects Charlene Tilton to throw at. Tony Danza from Who's the Boss has been a prize fighter, wisely got out of that. I'm not Heather Locklear, you know. The commissioner is ensconced beside me, as is Shari Belafonte Hoffa.
No, I'm going to hit the camera if I don't.
You ready? Girl.
Hey, that hit the target. That hit the target but didn't dump her. That's 1 point, Howard.
All right, we give Danza 1 point.
I'm glad I was glad I was able to remember that in the rules.
Let's replay that first hit.
And take a look at it one more time here, Coach. He just grazed the target. Didn't break the trap or the trapeze didn't go, but here it is again. Watch this. Just grazed the top of the target, and we got to give him 1 point for that. Right there. Didn't move it. I don't understand it. How does Shari Belafonte knock that thing and it breaks?
What can I say? It's all in the arm.
Well, Tony Lobianco selects Deborah Shelton.
Howard, isn't Tony the baseball champion of Broadway?
Well, the show business. That's right.
Howard, true or not, he struck out. Did he or did he not?
Strike out.
Tony.
Woody Allen.
Four times? Come on. Nah, give me a break.
Peaked out early.
Evidently.
Well, you know.
Don't
lose your concentration. Come on.
Look at this.
Underhand delivery. That's the way he pitches in the Broadway show business.
I can understand how I got Allen 4 times now.
That's 3 points.
Total of 4 points for ABC thus far.
Okay, concentrate.
Look at this guy. Two in a row, 3 more points for Lobianco. Hey, Howard, watch it. You see his style? Gets back behind the pitching rubber, or that rubber that they're using out there. Stands up on it, and then makes his throw.
Can I have a turn? One turn. Got out.
This guy can throw. Look at this.
Shari, don't you wish you were up there? Huh?
Nothing.
3 in a row. Hey, 9 points.
That ties him with Tom Selleck, Greg Harrison, and Scott Baio. They're the others who, in the past, have hit all three.
Howard, you know he's feeling good right now, don't you? Huh?
Yeah.
He's the MVP.
To throw at a woman who looks like that, you can feel extra bad.
He's the MVP. 3 in a row for Lobianco.
10 points for ABC. Coming up now for ABC with a chance to clinch the victory. There she is again. our Hawaiian heroine, Tracy Scoggins.
Michael Fox, come on. Right. This guy won't sink.
Where'd you come up with that one?
I don't know. I'm just taking a look at him here. I don't think he'll go underneath the water.
Jerry likes Michael.
Oh, he's a great guy.
Oh, he's a beautiful little guy. What a pass rush he put on Lobianco to ice it in the football game.
He's lucky Lobianco's not throwing at him. Get back at him.
Tracy's a good athlete here.
She's throwing Lobianco style.
And it works!
And it works!
That's it! That 3 points clinches it for ABC, Bob.
That's all they needed.
Michael Fox, all right. 1 for 2 for Scoggins. She knocked him in. Here it is again.
That's it. ABC doesn't need to throw any more balls. ABC is now at 13, NBC is at 12, and CBS is 3.
Let's have fun.
Sure, John Davidson is having fun, but he's going to sit out the event. What about the other celebrities?
Well, no. I have no malice in my heart for the other teams. I wish them well, except in the ratings.
So this is the dunk tank. You get 3 throws, 3 potential points. The object? Submerge your enemy. You loved it at home and you told us about it. Such a crowd, please, to watch you get soaking wet. Let's look at some historical dunks now as your favorite celebrities get the ultimate in revenge. Flashback, we flash forward as Newhart's William Sanderson steps up to the mound. This guy is really dizzy, you know that, Sherry?
I'm on your team, man.
He's trying to pick somebody from his own team.
Typical. Look at Lamas. He knows he's a dizzy one.
I think the captain better take him over there. Oh, there he goes.
Oh, he's showing him the list. The donkeys.
Sure he can. He's right here.
Right, so? Who's he going to put out there? Greg Evigan.
Not the worst possible choice, judging by Greg's performances thus far.
However, he's dressed for the part, clearly.
There's something in the way he walks.
Hey, sweetheart.
Should take his sunglasses off.
Okay. That's 1 down.
Up.
2 down.
Someone that counts. That's enough.
And 3 down.
Greg is safe, at least for the time being.
Charlene Tilton.
A little one from Dallas. And you know, I've seen her in this competition before, and she's very good. She'll surprise you, I predict it.
She's very good, and she's putting Greg back up in the booth.
I'd like to see him get the dunk. All right, let's watch closely. Close, but no score.
She also has another toss.
Mm-hmm.
Get another one?
Don't be bitter. She gets another one, Greg. She can, huh? Well, he's trying to disconcert her. Look at him making faces. Let's see if it works. I doubt it.
Yes!
Yes!
It works. He didn't go in a second time.
But she scored 3 points for CBS.
It was bright enough not to pick someone from her own team.
Let's look at it in replay. Good form. Hit it right in the butt, right in the middle, and down one Evigan. If ever I've seen an overconfident fool, it was Evigan.
All right, up for NBC is Clifton Davis.
I like this guy, but I want to see him get a taste of the water.
Yeah, but you know the Lord's on his side.
Amen.
Oh, he's going after Daphne Maxwell Reed from Frank's Place. You know, those were her shoes that Greg Evigan borrowed in the last go-round.
Good line by Clifton. You know, he doesn't know I saw him, but he's here. Her husband, Tim Reed.
Ah, you're lovely.
And a wonderful sprinter, isn't he? Yeah.
The best we ever had on the Battle of the Network Stars. By the way, Shari talked to Cliff about competing.
I feel good, you know, for a guy in his mid-40s. You know, I don't feel bad at all that I can come out and compete with folks that are literally half my age. I feel great about it.
All right, here he goes.
He misses the first one.
He's got an obvious problem. He's looking at that beautiful lady instead of at the target. See what I mean?
Yep. This is the second one.
It's got nothing to do with age in his case.
Oh, wow. He's missed the third one, too. So now NBC still has no points.
And Malcolm Jamal Warner shows his disgust.
Don Lewis from A Different World. She's up next.
Anybody on the board? Anybody on the board?
I want to pick Lorenzo Lamas because he beat me swimming.
I wonder if he's going to show the tattoos again. They helped him the last time in the swimming.
But they didn't help him in the kayak, so. Oh, looks like he's not going to show them.
Yeah. I bet. It ain't gonna happen, honey. I'll just keep on saying it.
You should go.
No way you can do it, honey. Nah. No way. Come on,
so far, still no points.
Listen, hotshot, I'd like to see you go in the dunk.
I have to tell you, I saw her practicing. This isn't her best event.
Close.
Ooh, very close.
NBC scoreless, CBS still ahead, but Dawn Lewis, perhaps in all of the battles of the network stars, no one has seen the charm, the bright eyes, the wonderful smile of this talented young woman. On NBC's Cosby spinoff, A Different World, she's Jaleesa Benson.
Photography is a great hobby of mine. The photography I like to do has a lot to do with putting images together, like looking at a tree and looking at clouds and looking at a sunset are three very separate entities. But when you look through a camera lens and you can see the sunset through the tree, you've created this picture that just forces you to just zero in on this little composition. I think is great. I love taking pictures of water. One of my favorite spots is a spot right underneath the Brooklyn Bridge. So you have the water and you have the bridge and you have the Manhattan skyline. So you get kind of everything in one little spot. When I was a kid, I grew up in a neighborhood. It was kind of like the East Side Kids where you would make things in your basement and just have this wild imaginative time. And that's basically what we did. Things like making burglar alarms out of the lamppost and string and tying pots and pans and the furniture together. So when you forget to tell mom that you did this and she walks home, the lamp comes crashing down and all that kind of stuff. We were real fun, imaginative kids. So I was very energetic all of the time. I get the urge to know you. dancing when I was about seven. My mom did that to get me away from my brothers. So I was kind of a tomboy. So now I'm a tomboy who can dance. It's hard work. Dancing is hard work. It takes a lot out of heart. It takes a lot out of energy, as well as technique and line and charisma. But if you can put all of the elements together, that's magic. It really is.
Quickly recapping the dunk tank, CBS 3 points, NBC scoreless. Up comes ABC for that chance at getting on the boards here in the baseball dunk. Brian Robbins up first, choosing Terry Copley from NBC.
Okay, let's see if Terry's going to go in or stay dry.
I think she has a hunch that she looks pretty good in this scene.
Well, she's getting prepared just in case she goes in.
Brian Robbins is a dangerous foe.
Yes!
A throwback to Heather Thomas and Heather Locklear.
Is there a lifeguard on duty?
All right, let's see if young Robbins can come through.
Terry has a look of anticipation about her face.
Please don't do it. Please don't do it.
A minute. This could cause a later controversy. Remember that throw, dear. Just
don't
remember.
Worry, don't all right. Worry,
don't worry. Don't do it.
This is that one.
I'll tell you, the guy deserves something. He's throwing well.
Oh. In she goes.
I don't know how she didn't go down in the other one.
Well, ABC has an unofficial 3 points right now with Robin throws.
All right, Robin, help her down. Because we've got another contestant coming up, but let's look at that in replay. Bango.
Olivia Davo's up next from ABC. Let's see who she's going to go after.
I want to tell you something. This is not too shabby either.
Her cousin, Marianne Davo, of course, from the James Bond movies.
Again, it's Lamas.
Surely he's got to go in this time.
Thank you for your support.
As he places his anatomy in the swing.
Yay!
Ooh.
Very close.
Very close.
Better throw than I expected from Olivia. Son of a gun sitting up there, isn't he?
Really?
I'm fine.
Hope she gets him.
The score, NBC 0, CBS 3, ABC unofficially 3. Now another look at the controversial throw from Brian Robbins. The ball hit, so it seemed to be another point for ABC. Let's check with Commissioner Matuszak.
Commissioner, will you explain why ABC won the event 4-3?
Well, even though he didn't dunk him on that one toss, he hit the target. When he hit the target, even though it's not a dunk, it's 1 point, so they won by points.
All great pitchers come from Brooklyn, so, you know.
Yeah, Brian!
First it was Colfax, and now it's Robin.
So after three events, here's how it tallies up. ABC and CBS both tied at 250 points, and NBC with 175 points.